it up.
It's Robert Kelly's You Know What Do podcast on riotcast.com.
Fat boy.
I love that we're doing another fat guy episode.
That was very mean, Joe.
You don't know the half of it. I got beefs, bro.
All right, first of all, Lewis, don't fucking talk over the intro.
Nobody can hear me talking over
the intro.
That's
the problem, is we hear you and we'll go,
you
what?
You can hear me. I was wondering why Joe DeRosa is still in the intro, yet your boy isn't in the intro. Your boy isn't in the intro. Dan Soder's not in the intro.
Yeah. Amy Schumer's in there. I wonder why she's in there.
Is Schumer in the intro?
Of course she's in there.
No, she's not.
Yeah, she is.
You're a star fucking bitch.
Yeah.
You're a fucking real star.
We both got beefs, bro.
You're a star fucking bitch.
Or, all right, hang on there, fucking
That's
chamber
why he has
boys.
You
relax.
On here.
Take it back a notch. Or I made the intro when they were all on the show a lot.
Incorrect.
And you weren't.
When Amy Schumer was on the show a lot?
She was on the show 4 times.
No, she wasn't. She was on maybe
She's
once.
She's been on
or
four
twice.
Times. She was in Montreal. She was up here
a
3 times.
A fucking road show at a festival? That doesn't count.
It was a fuck. Dude, are you crazy? It was Pete Corelli, Gary Gulman, Rich Voss.
Yeah, the regulars.
Fucking, and Colin Quinn, Amy Schumer,
yeah,
Joe DeRosa.
You're a star fucker.
Billy Burr.
Star fucker.
You're a star fucker, star fucker,
star
fucker.
No, it's
not.
Those are all
star.
The people. They, for, if you let me explain, they gave me a list. Of people who
Joe's
were at
there.
Who were at the fuck. Will you shut the fuck up and just stop swinging?
Puns, bro.
I know. It's just fucking puns. Listen, you're right. I should change the intro to put Joe and Dan in it.
My last time on the show, guys. Thank you very much. It's my the finale. The Lewis R.I.P. Lewis J. Gomez.
You say that every other 6
episodes. No, I don't. Shut the fuck up, Scopo.
Why are you going to get so violent out of the gate?
I'm not getting violent.
It's because the shorts he's wearing. Did you see how tight these shorts are? He looks like he's ready to cycle out of here to the Tour de France.
You really do wear 4 different sizes of shorts and shorts.
Can we not defer from Bobby being a star fucker?
I wish I was a star fucker. I really do. I wish I had that gene. I just don't. I hang out with people like
you. You can't
like
fit
you.
Into jeans.
How was that?
Lewis laughed. I'm not doing the thing. I stopped falling for the thing. I know the thing that
What's
you do.
What's the thing?
You ask a guy to repeat the joke knowing that
I
a repeat of a joke
buddy,
bombs. I know the fucking trick, dog.
I did not hear it.
Joe's
I said you can't fit into jeans.
Today.
Yeah, funny.
It's been so much
fun. All right, listen. There's a lot of fucking beefs. But before we get into you and your stupid Manson lamps, your thousand-yard stare that you keep fucking giving me, your goma pile. This is my rifle.
Gomite pile.
Pile of gomites.
Title.
Not, neither one of them will write it down.
First of all, we did it already.
Writing it.
Thank you, Lauren.
Oh, I gave her the look. I was the look.
Oh, that's where you're at now?
You just get
look
at the way Lauren holds her pen. She holds it in between her middle finger and her ring finger.
Is that bad?
That's a sign of a divorced woman. I'll tell you that.
That is creepy.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, maybe I'll get divorced.
Ooh, okay.
Ooh.
All right, so right now we want to just announce that the premium membership, you can go to riotcast.com and join the hit the premium button and become a premium member. You can also go to for Android and iOS devices. Our brand new apps are free.
iOS.
And you can iOS if you're Puerto Rican. You can download those apps on your phone, and the shows go right to you from the app. They're amazing. They're free, and you can join right from the app. Premium members. The show from last week. Podcast live at the Podfest is up there with the video, which was an awesome. I mean, I literally just took a bashing the whole show from everybody.
I felt we hurt your feelings a little bit.
No, I thought it was pretty funny.
Oh, all right.
You guys were all on fire at the same time, though. It was kind of.
You know what Soder did that annoyed me? In the cab, he's like, "Dude, you killed. I fucking bombed." But I'm like this.
No, he's right.
I killed. He fucking murdered. Lewis Soder killed the hardest of everybody. We were all on. He killed the hardest. I wish Soder would just embrace, I'm fucking killing
it. He's talented?
I crush it. I'm in movies. I'm in TV. I'm loving it. I'm a sweet guy still. But yeah, I fucking murdered. You murdered. I murdered. I got a huge, enormous head physically. You killed also. You were great.
Thanks.
I thought Lewis did great.
But Sutter, he's too
humble. Even though this is your last episode, I thought you did great on that episode.
It's not a big deal, guys.
Too humble, Dan Soder. Don't you think?
No, I don't think it's
humble.
No,
that's what he does.
Yeah.
Dan Soder,
yeah.
It's just another level. See, he's likable on a, like, it's like a fucking, you peel apart the layers, and there's more likable in there.
Yeah.
But what he does is he just wants to be even more, if he comes off like, yeah. like me, I'm a cocky motherfucker. Everyone hates me, and yeah. I always talk about how much I kill.
Keep going.
Yeah. So,
keep going.
So, but Dan does the opposite of that. Dan is very humble, but almost like that's his angle. It's like, hey, I don't kill guys. And then everyone goes, oh, no, he killed. And they talk about
exactly.
it.
Exactly. He wanted, I believe this. That was this. Dude, no, you killed. I did okay. No, you killed too. That's what he wanted.
But he fucking murdered. He was
good.
Murdering that
yeah,
show.
He was good. He I bombed. If anybody bombed, I bombed.
I agree. For sure, yeah.
Wait a minute, guys.
I had the best line, though. Remember? Scobo was mad. Scobo was mad at me.
It was
well, you set it up real well.
What was it?
Oh, that was a great
you
one.
You said there was words you can't say. And I said there's some words I can't say either. Great set, Scopo.
Still kills. Fucking still kills.
That'll kill every. You should open. And that should be the intro.
And if you want, I will. If you want to hear that episode and hear that great line, you got to go to the premium membership. So go there. It's $1.99 a month. It's nothing.
You should have heard what Bobby said about Amy Schumer on that episode.
Oh,
only,
yeah.
You'll only hear it on the premium episode.
Yeah.
Yeah, boy. Premium. Jesus Christ, you really do know
it's
how to sell
weird,
shit.
Weird smell you described.
So let's introduce the guest here.
All right. Am I right? We have a very funny comic from Canada, Tyler Morrison, everybody.
Hey. Thanks for having me on. It's
Sean
great.
Donnelly Light.
Great to be here in a city that actually has black people. I've come from just north of Toronto. We have no one.
Wait,
none?
What's great about that?
What? What's wrong with you, bro? I got to mix it up a bit.
We Tyler Morrison's a good fight name.
Yeah,
like a fighter.
Like the Tommy Morrison,
Tommy
the guy who died of AIDS there.
Yeah.
He died?
He didn't have AIDS, by the way.
No, he had AIDS. He was psychotic.
I was joking.
He was in denial, right?
Just bad chlamydia.
That's good. All right, who else?
Then we have the Puerto Rican rattlesnake, Luis J. Gomez.
Are those your bombs?
my grenade launcher.
He also calls them jokes. Well,
alrighty. The truth, Joe List.
Yep.
I got beefs, dude. Kind of with beefs.
I like your guns better.
He's got lasers.
Yeah.
More entertaining than his fucking World War II reenactment he did.
What's the Berg nickname? You got a nickname?
Yeah. Big
Jew.
Little Hulk. Big Jew, what?
I like Big Jew. Yeah.
Big Jew, Little Hulk. That sounds fun. That's like a poem.
Yeah.
Like me if I had willpower.
Yeah. You were in shape for, like, I remember a headshot.
God damn it.
I like the idea that you think you're willpower away from looking like that. I'll take the bomb, Dana.
Aaron, how you doing?
I'm great.
Did you bring any Stogues?
I got a half a nub in my pocket, and then I thought.
And he's also got a cigar.
I'm talking about your dick.
And then, I thought you were going to give me a stick today because I gave you a stick last time.
Wow.
But yeah.
Sorry, I didn't bring one. I'll tell you why. Can I tell you why?
You, I know you have some stories.
I don't. I took them home.
Yeah.
I wish I didn't, but I smoked them all this weekend. I have around 300 cigars at my house.
That's good.
All Primo cigars, and I love them.
Yeah.
And I actually, the ones that the fans brought in recently, I smoked them all this weekend.
I can't wait till they have to remove your lips for cancer, and you just have to do the show
it's
with
not
just
the
your
lips.
Teeth.
It's just the gums.
Just the bottom.
And tongue.
I got a box of my father. That just arrived today.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
What kind?
The Bijou, the number one rated last year's number one.
My father's cigar.
My father, yeah.
A box
the Cubans are, the band is lifted, right?
Yeah,
the embargo?
But you can't get,
yeah, but you can't get them. And they're not even that, it's not even that much of a difference between the cigars we have now and what they, actually, some of them are better because they said the soil, because of the government, and they fucked up and they didn't treat the crops right or the soil right, so it's not as, some of them aren't even as good, so.
You didn't really say anything there.
So
you said the, soil, the government.
Yeah. Sounded fucking good to
that's
the
how,
novice.
That's how cigar connoisseurs write it off, though. It's either the soil, the sun,
you
the
didn't
government,
say a word.
The growing conditions, or that year the labor was horrific.
Well,
you could say
because
that.
You have to, with the, like in Nicaragua or
Dominican. Come on.
The Canadian guy comes on and says he hasn't seen black people and you're throwing around Nicaragua like that.
Hey,
Nicaraguan cigars.
We'll take it out in post.
These Nicaraguans.
Nicaraguans.
Such a tasty word.
Keep on moving into the neighborhood.
Nicaraguans.
I love that Scobo just looked at Lauren again and gave her the write that down look. She's got it.
I didn't on that one, but all right.
If you name this Nicaraguan, I have a new level of respect for you.
I used to play baseball back in Nicaragua.
Oh, my God.
Is that black people water?
I can't be a party of this.
Nicaragua.
Nicaragua.
Just, just let them do it. Just let them do it.
I want to go out for that MTV show that Lewis went out for today.
You went out for a show today.
Yeah, Yo, Is This Racist? I don't think it's a show yet. I don't think we can talk about it.
As soon as Lewis walked in, they go, yes.
Did you really audition? Did they call
you? It was a show about racism, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Did they call you?
Yeah.
Really? So funny. How funny is it if you get on a show being a racist and that's how you become famous?
Yeah.
Joking about just being a joking racist.
I should have brought the Nicaragua line.
Yeah. We just thought of it. Yeah. Yeah. You got a call back. There you go.
Yeah.
They actually have an island off the coast of Maine called Negro Island.
I know Negro Island. You know Negro Island?
Yeah.
Booth Bay Harbor.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude. It's
have you ever been to the Chink Peninsula?
Wow.
Look at the Canadian.
Spick
the
Reservoir.
The Canadian's blushing.
No, I've never been to South Korea.
Jeez.
That was funny, Jeff.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Thank you. What are you fucking Roddy Dangerfield? Thank you.
Hey.
I didn't bring the cigars this morning because I woke up very early. And went and bought.
Cry me a river.
I bought two folding webbed vintage folding chairs.
Yeah.
Off of Craigslist. So I had to go. I ran out this morning early to go to this lady's house and buy these chairs. And I didn't have my wallet with me.
Yeah.
So I went and bought these chairs. I had no money, no wallet, and I almost ran out of gas.
That's a great move, by the way. Order coffee, then pretend not to have your wallet. 99% of the time, they just give you the coffee.
Here's another good move. At Starbucks, it might not work if you're brownish, but if you're a white person, you go up to the where they get the coffee and stuff. You go, I got my coffee, but they forgot my cookie. And they just automatically go and get you a cookie.
Yeah.
They never question you. You just go, I'm waiting on a cookie. Yeah. Especially if it's busy.
They wouldn't question you.
You do this?
Yeah. I do it. Well, I do it by accident. Not by accident, but I've done it twice.
Yeah, they're not going to question you. I invented Facebook face, but they will question this fucking dark circled.
He's yelling at them.
Greg Stone had the best scam ever.
Yeah, that's a good
What's
one.
That?
Yeah,
where you go to like Shake Shack, and then you order a double cheeseburger, and then when they bring it to you, be like, oh, I ordered two cheeseburgers. And then they usually just let you keep the double cheeseburger, and then they bring you two single cheeseburgers. So you walk out with three burgers.
Yeah.
It's fucking fat genius.
Yeah. Four patties.
Yeah, that really just fucking stunned me.
Yeah.
Or you could just pay for your stuff.
Yeah. Not be a piece of garbage.
Norman will still get the water cup at Chipotle and get a Coke.
What?
Amy Schumer pays him $25,000 a show. He's still stealing sodas from Chipotle.
Jesus.
There's something charming about it.
Some guy got arrested for that recently.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
For what?
He said he was going to get a water and put a Coke in there, and they arrested him.
You can't get arrested for that.
Well, you're stealing.
Scopo's going to Google it.
First of all, don't
see the resentment. You can see the resentment.
Why would I lie about this?
Because you're dumb and you misread a story. Somebody told you
that. Happened.
I guarantee somebody told you that and it was a lie and you're reading it like you read a newspaper.
Where was it?
That's such a bullshit arrest, though.
All right, can you not talk in the mic while you're looking? Yeah. Do a Gomez and push it away.
Hear about that guy that got arrested, Tom?
Tom Green?
He rented the Tom Green movie Freddy Got Fingered on VHS and never returned it. And then they came and arrested him for having all these overdue.
For just having that movie?
Yeah.
Worst movie of fucking. I mean, am I out of my mind? Green.
Hey, he's Canadian.
Is that movie fucking terrible?
Yeah, it was. Bad.
Canadians just cannot be funny. Ever.
Yeah, well, let's not get carried away. There's got to be a fun. Ryan Reynolds is fucking hilarious.
Jim Carrey.
Jim Carrey's hilarious.
Yeah.
Who else?
Me.
That's it.
Phil Hanley?
Here.
Hey! Phil Hanley's hilarious.
Bobby.
Yeah.
Look.
Read it.
Man charged for filling McDonald's water cup with soda.
Is that the guy with the mustache?
A man is facing felony charges after allegedly filling his free water cup with
felony charges?
Not free soda Monday at McDonald's.
Time out. How is it felony charge? Then he shot the place up.
Police say 18-year-old Cody Morris
was refreshing himself after a raping.
And two others drove through the McDonald's drive-thru and ordered three large waters. Then, make it bigger.
Yeah, make it bigger so we can all read it, you fucking ass clown.
It didn't even make it bigger, by the way.
It didn't even make it bigger. Yeah.
What are we doing? Are we turning into a fucking radio, though?
Morris,
we're reading news stories?
Returned with sodas.
All right.
By the way, we just want to prove that Scopo can't read.
Yeah. But he was good at the beginning, then he just started mumbling.
McDonald drink.
Yeah, he's like a fucking newcomer at the AA meetings.
How was the felony charges?
One day at
I don't
a
know.
Time.
Charges.
Read through and then come back around.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Thank you, Lewis.
No problem, man.
For producing the show.
When?
I should have listened to you around a year ago.
You remember when I said I'd come in and produce the show, help you book it? Yeah. You got three people who can't do the job I would do by myself.
We were supposed to book it.
First
I
of
forgot
all,
about that.
First
what
of
happened
all,
to that?
Let's calm down.
I love her. She's great.
I do love her.
And I love fucking Deepu. You can't. You
He's
wouldn't
love fucking him? You fuck Deepu?
I would fuck Deepu.
Bobby Fox Deepu. Bobby Fox Deepu. Bobby Fox Deepu. And his dick smells like shit.
Giving new meaning
and,
to
and fucking
deep
Scopo,
poo.
Scopo fucking books the show.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And he does a lot of stuff.
I get cokes.
No, Scopo's great. Listen, fuck off, Joe. What's your beef with me?
Oh, I got so many. Which one do you want? You want to go
the,
from like medium
the,
to
I want,
high?
I want
Is it
the
t-shirts?
High.
The t-shirt beef?
Well,
no.
I mean that's just an ongoing. You owe me $350. No
it's
sweat.
Not, how does it keep? It went from 200.
It's 370.
To 270. To 370.
I think it's 270.
You're lying. It's
go to
two
the tapes.
It's two something. Go ahead.
It's two something.
You're it's getting
a, I
the check.
Few other beefs.
You're getting this check this weekend, by the way.
$50 spot.
You're getting
pay.
All. You're getting everything this week. You're done.
There's some other things
you're
too.
You're done.
There's some other things too. I never brought up because I'm intimidated
go.
By you because
Let's
you're a bully.
Go.
I feel weird because I don't want to bring it up. And
you're,
then you're
a
like,
bully. You're a bully. You're a bully.
I don't want to bring it up, and then you're like, dude, you don't do that on the
he
show.
He does reverse
you're fucking
bullying.
Food.
Cry bullying.
You are. You're. Thank you. What fucking.
You know it's bullying? Tell her you're going to give someone money and then not giving them the money, bro.
No, that's just lying. That's not bullying.
Yeah, he's just
or,
being a filthy liar.
Yeah.
Or you leave every time I'm ready to write you the check.
Yeah.
Oh, interesting.
You fucking run out of here.
If you cared, maybe it would be ready. Pressed and ready. Envelope.
Now I have to care. Now I have to care. I have to fucking not bully. I have to have that. What do you want
but
from me?
Here's the thing. Here's what I realized. I know why I'm not getting my money.
Why?
I'm your little East Coast friend. I'm your little East Coast, New York.
What is that?
You're
what
on my show,
mean?
Buddy friend.
You're not a star.
Because we're over there in Hollywood, out in Hollywood. Bobby posts a big picture with his big old dick-sucking cigar over in Hollywood, prepping for Marin's show. I go, what? I'll show you the timeline, everything. I got screenshots. I go, what the fuck? You're in L.A.? I'm in L.A., you motherfucker. This is crazy. We're going to have the time of our lives. No response.
No.
3 days.
Oh,
3 days.
Come
and
on.
I'm literally, I'm sobbing. People are like, I thought Bobby was in New York. I thought I saw on his thing. He's in L.A. I'm like, I don't know. I don't get it.
I bet you if Schumer or Burr called him up, he would have definitely.
Dude, he posted a picture with all of them, the whole knuckleheads. He's doing a pyramid with fucking Bradley Cooper and some other dudes. And then I text and go, hey, what's the deal? You in L.A. or am I gay? What's going on? This is crazy. And then he goes, yeah, tomorrow let's have a smoke. I go, yeah, let's have a smoke tomorrow. He goes, I got Marin from 11 to 12. And I go, how about lunch? We'll do lunch. He goes, great. I go, I can't wait. Never heard from him. Never
we
heard
know,
anything.
We know you ate lunch.
Never heard from him.
Twice.
First of all,
that day.
Okay, are you?
Bobby had lunch, mid-lunch, and then afternoon, late lunch.
Can I say something? Okay.
Sure.
He wrote, you're in L.A. You're in L.A. I'm in L.A. Let's hang. And he sends me a photo with John Stamos.
Yeah.
Which I thought was fake.
It's hilarious.
But I heard the whole story
can we see
about
the photo?
That Stamos thing.
So yeah, but it's real. He's with fucking John Stamos.
Is Stamos as handsome in real life as
he is? Unbelievable.
Is
I would
really?
Suck Stamos' dick and shoot it in his face.
So he's with Stamos. I think whatever. So now I'm flying in. It's a long fucking
No, you're
night.
Already there. You already posted a picture. Don't fucking twist, dog.
So now Wednesday, okay?
Mm-hmm.
This is Wednesday. I post, are you in LA? He posts, see previous text, bro. I'm at Ari's taping right now. I post. I'm
it's not a post. It's a text.
Yeah, what are you posting?
Yeah.
I text. Thank you for the correction.
But then he writes, notice the little subtle thing. Like he doesn't know. Like this. Hey, are you in L.A.? Acting all suspicious. I sent you a text with Stamos. Where else would Stamos be besides Greece?
I thought it was a fake. I thought it was fake.
San Francisco. That's where the show was.
Oh, that's
I
right.
thought it was
if
fake.
If you're hanging out with Stamos, why the fuck do you want to hang out with Bobby Kelly?
Thank
for
you. Whoa.
Because I
listen. Because
I love him.
Let me finish my posts.
Yeah.
Text.
Okay. I love that it made everybody.
Yeah, your
really,
post.
It was just bugging me.
It was 11 more posts about Mac Maron, your buddy.
Shut up. I'm at Improv smoking cigar.
Were you at the Improv or V-Cut?
I was at V-Cut.
Okay.
Next door.
I was there all day.
I was at V-Cut next door all day, taping. I have smoking there tomorrow at around 11 o'clock. If you want to join, I'm doing Married 11 till 12. Lunch plans? Sounds good. I will call you when I'm done. Now.
Never called.
I'm going to tell you why. Can I fucking explain?
If it starts with, I'm really sorry. You can?
First of all, you're bullying me into being nice. You're nice bullying.
I'm sorry.
You're bullying me.
Why are you apologizing when you're asking him to apologize?
Shut up. Why don't you mind your business?
I'm sorry I asked you to apologize.
You know what?
I just didn't know that I was your East Coast friend and not your West Coast friend.
You're my friend all over. Huh. Worldwide.
Can you also explain to him that when you go to L.A., priorities change a little bit? If you're there for business, you don't want to see the lackey that runs around
Hang
your
on
podcast.
One second.
That's how it works everywhere else.
How do you know that?
I've been to L.A. once.
Okay. Yeah.
We're from Boston, dog. We're supposed to stick together, bro.
I was going to meet you at V-Cuffs.
Uh-huh.
I went 11. I got there at 11. We didn't start till like 11:30, quarter 12. And then right after, we didn't get it done until 1:30. 1:30, almost 2 o'clock.
I was starving by then, waiting for you.
Yeah. Look at him, Bobby. He hasn't eaten. Right. I got a massive sinus headache.
Oh.
I got a massive sinus headache.
Oh.
Sinus headache.
Sinic.
I went
That's hard to type.
I went the fuck home. I went right back to the hotel and took a medication, my sinus medication, and went to bed. By the time I woke up,
8 o'clock,
it was done. I was done. So yeah, dude, I couldn't go smoke a cigar.
Why didn't you text him though to tell him that you had a massive sinus headache?
And why did it take 2 days for you to respond to, "Hey, I'm in L.A. Let's hang, John Stamos"?
Because the
The first text I sent, I was like, "Oh man, you're in L.A. I'm in L.A. Let's hang."
Yeah.
A couple days.
I wasn't in L.A. I was in Boston still.
Interesting.
Wasn't I?
I don't know. That's
not what the Instagram post said.
Listen, man, I fucking would have loved to hang with you. And I'm going to give you this right now. Look at me. Look at me. Look at me. Joe, I'm sorry.
Thank you, Bobby.
Sorry.
Thank you, Bobby.
You know what? It's not my last show because you showed that much manhood. That should feel good.
I really did. I really wanted to smoke a cigar with you. I love hanging with you.
I was at the V-Cut all day.
And
two days in a row. 4 hours each day.
I couldn't make the V-Cut.
Just waiting for him?
I'm not kidding. I love it.
I love it, too. The V-Cut's great.
Derek?
The young guy that works there? Yeah.
Love Derek.
Nice guy.
Love him.
Yeah. Joe is an aggressive smoker, by the way. Have you smoked with Joe before?
Are you on your phone?
I smoke hard and fast, bro.
I was just finding my text to you. So Joe is an aggressive smoker. He smokes very quickly.
That's because he already had his jaw removed from cancer.
Yeah.
I thought that was a good one.
Thanks.
I thought it was a good one.
Yeah, you would, because you don't like me anymore.
I love you, man.
All right, whatever. How
was
Maren?
Joe, he gave you the sorry.
I appreciate it.
Maren was great.
I got other beefs, too.
Maren was
great. We go to Lauren's tits now?
No.
Yep, we can go to the titties. Yeah, let's talk about
it. She told me she'd go on a date with me, basically.
I did not.
Yeah.
You kind of did.
I saw it. I was
kind
outside.
Of.
He goes, let's go out. And I go, Lewis would be a good guy to rebound with, and he's a good first date.
I said, okay, and I walked away.
Can I say something, Lauren?
What?
If you went out with Lewis on a date, I would not mind that.
Okay.
I'd be okay with that.
Were you going to take me to McDonald's?
So it is happening.
No, he'll take you somewhere easier than that.
No, he's going to take you to Shake Shack, and he's going to order a double cheeseburger, and then he's going to get two extra ones.
Bro, my fucking girlfriend ordered a double.
What about Scub? Are you single?
I am single. Yeah.
There you go.
No, that won't work.
No.
Why not?
Scopo comes too quick.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But he looks like a young Christian Slater. How could you fucking
He does look a little
guy?
Slatery.
Oh, I can
I like
see
Slatery.
That.
Yeah, all right. Yeah. I think
Good
a Slatery.
Call. Good call.
Like getting Mark Wahlberg.
Like a Slatery, Christian like, pulled Slater. His fucking nose out of his face.
Yeah.
You remember in Beetlejuice? Beetlejuice when they fucking changed their faces?
That's Michael Keaton.
He does not look like Christian Slater at all.
Yeah, he does.
He does.
Don't take this away from me.
That's we all
hair.
Said yes.
He has hair from Heather's, but that's it.
Yeah.
That's it.
Great hair, good ass.
And you got your friend on the couch. What's your friend's name?
You brought a gay guy.
Jarrett.
Are you gay?
Yeah, I just came here to blow Tyler.
Hey, what happened to you? Did you get shot in the arm?
It's Freddie Mercury's brother, the gay one.
Here, buddy.
What is that?
I was moving some boxes and I got poked and I think my liver's failing.
Oh, that's cool. Where are you from?
Yeah, dude, that's from just touching a box with your arm.
What are you, John Travolta and Boy in the Bubble?
Yeah, it's coming to an end.
Talking about great hair, though. I mean, if I had to pick hair in the room, I'd pick his.
Oh, wow.
Not his facial hair.
No, it's fucking hair, dum-dum. Yeah. Stop swinging.
It's a little oily.
His hair's not bad.
Huh?
I don't know him.
Yeah, but just have a good one.
I don't know him.
He's a facial hair. It doesn't look stupid.
I think Scopo's got the best hair.
No way.
Yep.
No way.
Yep.
Bobby's just jealous.
You could turn Scopo's hair into movie star hair.
Scopo looks like he styles his hair with the pussy juice of a 16-year-old.
What the fuck's going on here? We're talking hair and not me?
Hey, listen, don't talk over each other. Could you shut the fuck up?
List is thinning.
Young man from Canada is trying to say something, and he's got a small little meek voice, okay?
I believe as part of the Liberal Conservative Party of Canada.
Something about free
healthcare. I'm just saying, Scopo looks like he styles his hair with the pussy juice of a 16-year-old girl. He's got it going on. He knows what he's doing.
All right, talk over him from now on. No, I'm joking. Listen.
You got to put that on your microphone, the bomb Dana.
There's no way, my friend, listen to me. There's no way that he has better hair. Scopo has better hair than... First of all, Scopo's up here is going. It's fading.
No, Scopo's not. List is going. List is losing his hair.
No.
I got a big forehead. My forehead's always been
list,
this size.
List has Russ Meneve hair. That shit's never leaving.
That's that's thinning. How old are you?
Thinning? What are you talking about thinning?
It's thinning.
My head has always been this high.
No, but on top, it's getting really thin, the
hair.
No. He's going to lose his.
I got full head.
He's not losing his.
No, my dad's got a full head of hair.
Look at that fucking hair.
He's got great hair, though.
It's in the integrity of the hairline. We got it. That's a good hairline.
How old are you?
28.
See, Bobby, he could still lose it. Scopo's going to keep his.
Listen, I'd rather have his hair than his hair.
I'd like Lauren's hair.
But you know, maybe I'll say this. Maybe I'd rather have his style than this fucking pompadour.
Yeah, you guys are talking style and product.
Yeah, Scopo really does have like the bad guy in
Grease.
Karate
Kid.
No.
The guy that rapes girls on a hot.
Back to the Future.
It's not gonna be funny
Biff
now.
Biff
he's got Biff in the 50s when he got punched.
50s.
But it's
when
so
did you
long
lose yours,
in the back.
Bobby?
What's that?
When did you lose yours?
I lost mine in my mid 30s, but I superseded it. I preempted. I had a preemptive strike. I had
the
hair.
Superseding hairline.
I had hair. I could have lasted another 5 years with my hair before you'd been like, oh shit, you need to do something with that. I did it when people were like, why did you shave your head? Just so, because I knew it was going to be a day. Yeah.
But it's better being, look, we got three bald guys in the room.
Yeah.
Isn't it just fucking better to just be like, I can shave it. I don't have to worry about it. I don't have to style
it. Not in this business.
That's not true. It's a look.
It pigeonholes
you. First of all,
it's absolutely
it absolutely is fucking true.
Yeah.
I was up for a part for Dane Cook's best friend called Robert, and I didn't get it. And he, at one point, we were doing a test in front of all the big wigs at Sony,
SAT.
Down to three people.
We're all wearing big wigs. Sorry, Bob, you have no hair.
It was down to me and me and two other guys. And at one point, I think Dane looked at the main Sony guy at Sony, and he goes, is it because he's bald? Is it because he doesn't have hair? Because he was fighting for me. And the guy went, we do like hair here at Sony.
Well, he was the main guy, so he had a mane.
Wow.
Bobby's looking for something hard to throw at.
Bobby, don't. Come on.
Bobby, empty water bottle.
You can't hit me for trying to make jokes.
Dude, it's not a joke, it's a pun. It's not even the same fucking realm.
Main.
This isn't a podcast
funny.
In the 40s. Yeah, well, you want to do fucking horse sounds too? A horse was coming in. And then the door opened.
Where is Soder?
Bobby Kelly's YKWD puncast.
Hey, so. It does
Speaking
matter.
Of soda,
you do get
I could use a Coke.
If you had hair, you could do different things.
You also wouldn't get the parts of like the badass bald guy as well.
Yeah, but that's the only parts you're
you
going
shave
down
your
for.
Head, though. If you want to get a part of a badass bald
guy,
but
that sucks.
When
you see a dude who has hair and then shaves it bald, it always looks like
cancer. But here's the deal: they can imagine you with shaving your head. Okay, they can do that.
They can put a wig on you.
You know how much a wig costs?
Not that much.
You're such a fucking
Bob,
idiot.
If you were that good, you would have gotten the part of Robert, and they would put a fucking wig on you. That's it.
It's not.
You ever see the Coneheads? That shit's crazy.
Yeah,
because of the main characters. Of the
you
movie.
Don't even fucking get it, dumb fuck. It costs a lot of money. You're looking at something to throw at me. That's not how it works.
Ever hear of?
You can't never throw something from that side.
Hey, Bobby.
I'll just break it up.
Bobby, do these words mean anything to you? Sam Malone.
Yeah, a lot of money.
Wig, bro.
Went bald on the show.
Wig.
And how much money it costs?
How much a wig costs?
$40. Do you know much money it costs for a wig? A makeup lady
wiggies.
To have a fucking wig?
I had a hairpiece, so it's about $300 a month for a good hairpiece.
Okay, you got a month of filming. $300, that's it.
That's way more than that.
Yeah,
$300. You had a
hair club for men.
You did, wait a minute. You did Andre Agassi?
Google the picture, find my hairpiece picture.
I want to talk. Can I ask you a question about this?
Yeah, Google that.
What made you do that? What made you...
Exactly, acting. I was like, I think I'll get better roles if I had hair. So I grew my hair on the sides. I went and got a hairpiece. Boom. First thing I went in for, I booked. And it was something that I wouldn't have booked with a bald head.
So exactly. Yeah, a wig. That's the point.
A wig, an expensive wig.
The point that I just made was that you can get a wig and get the part.
Yeah, but my point was if you had hair, you'll get more parts. You'll have more opportunities.
Berg, is there a photo
of
you?
Can I just say something? Lewis, if you grew your hair out and just had whatever shitty hair you had.
I had really curly.
If you just grew it out a little bit and just had hair, you'd get more parts, acting-wise, because they can do more with you.
That's wiggity-whack.
You'd have more diversity. You could play a bunch instead of the fucking angry Puerto Rican guy.
Angry Birds.
Where is he?
Did you find it? The one with hair?
Were you on dates? What are you doing?
I'm trying to find it.
We got it. Put it away.
They're trying
it's
to
a fucking
Aaron
annoying
Berg
when I look over and you fucking your head's down all the time.
Just type in Aaron Berg and look at all the images.
I did.
Let me ask you a question. Were you on dates with it? Did you get addicted to having hair?
I couldn't do stand-up with it. I'd cover it when I did stand-up because it felt so...
So you
not
knew?
Genuine.
Did you know that comics knew?
Some knew, some didn't.
So it was like a secret.
No, but the guys that knew would know. They'd just look at my head and be all weird and be like,
"Hey, so you showed up one day with no better hair."
Yeah,
and nobody said anything to you.
A couple people would stare at it, but
yeah, but
I think
no one said, "Dude, you fucking losing."
Dude, that's a hair piece. No,
like
one said
would.
That. No one said that.
No,
yeah,
was that in Canada?
Yeah.
Oh, you fucking Canadians.
Yeah, too polite.
Do you know how trashed you'd get if you walked into
trashed.
The cell? With hair
trash.
One day. Oh, God. That'd be the greatest thing ever to see him walk in with hair.
Hey, guys, what's up? just play it off like nothing
just
happened.
Just putting a comb back in his pocket.
It's old 50s music. Who put the bop in the bop, shabop, shabop? That's a good song.
Did you, let me ask you a question. Did you go on dates with the hair?
Dude, look at Aaron Berg's fucking muscly picture. Go back up, though. That's not him? Can we look at him?
I had a fiance at the time.
You had a
she was supportive of it because she had fake breasts, so she
oh, fun.
She was supportive.
Way different.
Of it.
That's fair.
Yeah, way different.
Way different.
Yeah.
Why? So what's the difference?
Well, dude, fake breasts are just
people hair actually piece. Like them.
Yeah, they're nice. They're inside. You can't.
See, I don't care for a fake breast.
You like dude, his hair grows. His hair grows. It gets loose.
Yeah,
I like your hair grows.
Yeah, girls,
where my
girls
fake
with fake breasts are
go.
Usually pretty loose too.
How long did you have the hairpiece for?
Maybe 6 months.
So, okay.
Yeah. Yeah. What, do you get to keep it when you're done?
You go in, you get like a new one every month. Because
you don't get to keep it when you're done. They take it back.
My ex-fiance has it somewhere.
Oh, she has your head.
Oh, wow.
Why did you not keep that?
Well, I moved in a hurry.
I want it for the studio. Can you get it?
I'm trying to get it. I don't want to talk to her anymore.
Will you please get it for the studio?
I stopped talking to her.
Can you ask her if we can have it?
I don't want to. I'm getting married to another girl. She's going to get upset. Then this hair
can piece comes
Scopo in the
mail. Can I have Scopo try to get it?
Yes.
Scopo, you can reach out.
I'll reach
out.
Please.
I'll give Scopo the info.
I would like to wear it. Do you think, does it smell?
Yeah. Oh, and it stink. Yeah, it's like 3 years old now.
Did it stink when you had to get it changed up?
No, but here's the thing. If you wore it outside, like one sunny afternoon, the color would start to change. That's how quick, because it was real hair.
Like transition lenses.
Yeah, it was horrible. So like that would get blonde, and then the sides are brown, and then everyone's like,
so no one said anything?
Why does this 40-year-old look like a surfer?
No one said anything when you came back with just no hair again?
A couple, no.
Did you get to pick the style?
Yeah.
What was it? Robin Hood Men in
Bobby,
Tights where the mole kept on moving on the guy's face?
I thought it was the best. When I was getting it done, I was like, this is the best thing I've done with my life because they put it on. And I'd been bald for years, and I was like, oh, fuck yeah. And I wanted it all long. And
it was Canadian one, so it wasn't as good as American yet because they always get, like, shit later.
Yeah. You could see the weave. There's glue.
Oh, no, the weed. We tightened it up with a screwdriver.
Is that Irish?
I don't know. Did my fucking dance out?
He started out Irish and then up Canadian.
Oh. I thought it was amazing.
I found this weekend in my pot of gold.
I like fucking Lewis's freckles. He has.
Those are new.
Lewis has adorable freckles on his dumb face.
Old Cocoa Puff face over here.
Yeah. Lauren, are we going to go on a date?
No, you're like a brother. I'm not
dating
you. No, I hate when women say that.
I'm going to make it happen. I will make it happen.
Lauren, you wouldn't let me take on a date and then come and review it on the show?
Why?
It's a great idea.
For
what
the show.
Do? Yeah,
for the show.
You're going to get fingered.
Yeah. Go out to dinner, go bowling, maybe like, you know, switch blades, slice some tires, kill some raccoons.
Babysit his kid while he goes out for a few hours.
The last thing I would want is those dirty, fat fingers in my vagina.
They're not fat fingers. I have nice fingers.
Oh, you got awful fingers.
Yeah, he's going to have a Legion of Skanks tattoo in your pussy.
That's always what I dreamed of.
Ugh. So are you like dating? Are you on the scene now?
I got a few prospects.
Oh,
crushing
wow.
D.
You got Scopo, you got Deepu, you got Lewis.
No, how do you, what kind not. Of guys are you dating now?
No one currently, but.
Oh, wow.
What are the prospects like?
Yeah. Okay.
So nobody is better than me, you're saying?
Oh, God, Lewis.
Pretty much.
No.
Lauren, stop acting like you're perfect, okay?
Listen, you're going to take
you wear
me
too
out
much
15
makeup.
Minutes later, you're going to be like, I'm going to do a podcast, and then you'd leave me.
I really love her impression. It's really good.
I'll tell you what, there should be a web series of comics fucking. Aren't you fascinated? Like Mark Norman, I'm going back to Norman again. He fucks 50 girls a week. Don't you want to see Mark fucking a girl?
No.
Isn't
no.
It
no.
Don't
no.
you picture it going,
robotic?
Girl, hey,
no.
Good.
You're such
hey.
A queen.
What do you mean, a queen?
I just want to fucking see your best friend fuck girls.
I want to see Lewis the same thing.
I
want to see him pull a move.
I fuck
can
with
you
a
imagine?
Beast.
I watched
not the
Lewis
fucking.
Fuck
I'm talking
once.
The moments
I
before
saw that.
The fuck.
Lewis?
Like the move. I would like to see
did
your
you
move.
Did you watch me fuck?
I saw Lewis fuck at Milano's bar on Houston Street.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
I know that bar.
Yeah. In the bathroom, and you could see him pumping away at this.
Lewis, you know what? Lewis fucks like an Egyptian sheik. Just lies there.
No, if I don't eat bad for 2 days straight, I fuck like a champ.
I want to.
If I eat bad, I'm just like my. I feel like I got to shit the whole time.
Because you do.
I'll be Don. You be you. We're in bed. Yeah. This is a okay. Wednesday night, 10 p.m. Babies.
Yeah.
Gnomes babysitting.
Can I be
Don? Yeah, no.
I'm Don. What are you doing? You taking my bit?
Look, he's taking your bit. Stop being a hack. Let him do it.
Yeah, let me have my bit.
Yeah, sit and relax. Take this.
Can I be Don next?
Take this one off.
All right. Good night, Bobby.
All right. Good night. I love you, babe.
Ruff, ruff, ruff.
Diva, shut the fuck up.
The
Diva.
Fucking dog's barking, Bobby.
Shut up.
Bobby, he's going to wait the fucking kid.
He's fine. I got him.
All right.
I got him.
No, you said no more babysitting. Bobby.
What?
What are you thinking? What are you thinking? You're laying there. I can see you with your eyes open thinking.
Yeah.
You dum-dum. I can see that you're thinking about something. What are you thinking about?
I'm thinking about that I'm going to leave you, and I'm going to leave the kid, and I'm going to go bang trannies in Brazil.
That would be ideal. That would be great. I'm sick of your business, your nonsense. The drumming, it's enough already with the drumming. And
first
I can't
of all, why
stand
is she turning Jewish?
I don't know.
Enough with the drumming.
I can't do voices. Bobby. I can't. I don't want to apologize to Don. I can't do voices or accents.
Well, first of all, Don goes to bed before me all the time. That's just it. I stay up later.
She just pretends to be asleep.
She
can't find a better man.
She goes to bed before me all the time. That's just it.
All right. Well, I'm trying to do a thing. Where I want to know what your move is like when you're trying to get laid.
You were trying to give you. We want to do your real
move. Okay. Here's
nobody
my move.
Fucking
here's
yes
my move.
To me.
Wait. You all schedule right. Sex night now, right?
Here's not anymore. We have. But
yeah.
Here's my move.
I schedule.
Ready? We're in bed together. Okay. At the same time.
Good night, Bobby.
All right. What's up? All right. I go. Zip. Do you want to fuck around? She goes, okay.
You said, do you want to fuck around?
I go, you want to fuck around? She goes, okay. And I run and I take a shower. And I scrub everything. Oh. I scrub
That's
it all.
It's so not romantic.
It's not.
Or sexy.
It's not. It's not. You're
you
absolutely
don't
want right.
to fucking shower before sex.
You shower
yeah,
after.
You do.
I like Lauren,
do you shower if you're before Bobby, sex? You do.
No.
yeah,
I like to lick it all off. I want it to smell and be weird. And I'll clean you up like a cat.
That's fucking gross. That's disgusting.
That's gross.
Such a fucking project rat. You really are just a hipster, dirty Brooklyn yuck.
First of all, I never lived in Brooklyn. I never lived in the projects, and I'm not a hipster.
Whatever you are,
yeah, we're
gross.
Way off on all those. you're a rich Pacific
do you like,
Wars, or North
do you
Wars.
Like, do you like smelly skinny. Shit? You fuck
no.
when it's dirty and smelly?
No.
Like all day long, you're out in the backyard and you're stinky and smelly, and then you're about to go to bed.
Just doing Canadian shit, chopping wood, hunting rabbits.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd rather have a shower before.
Take a shower. You're going to bang your chick, right?
It's respectful.
Just growing into what about you?
No Luke? Way.
What are you, just bang straight out?
Yeah,
from
we
the wilderness.
Peel each other's clothes off. We fucking lick each other's sweat off each other's bodies.
Are you talking about my wife or a chick I meet on
I'm
the road?
I'm imagining your wife.
You're talking about like a chick I meet on the road, or are you talking about my wife?
Your wife, whoever.
Oh, my wife, yeah, that's who I take a shower. Some chick, you know, if I met randomly,
no, you fucking,
I'd fucking
you gotta,
just eat
you start
box.
Making out, you fucking take each other's clothes off, You're a little smelly. I like when a chick's a little bit
smelly.
How
do you know?
That's
what I said. You don't have a wife. You don't have a fucking girlfriend.
Fuckface. Do you understand
how
much?
You're alone.
Yeah, really alone.
Oh, I'm sorry. When we fuck with you, it's not funny. Everything gets serious when you get fucked with, you fucking idiot. That's what you do, you fucking idiot. Every time somebody zings you, you get fucking serious. Settle down. Take it.
Well, yeah, why don't you fucking say something true then, you fucking faggot?
It is true. You're alone. You got nobody.
I got plenty
you
of chicks.
You got nobody.
Bitches.
Nobody. I said bitches. You got nobody. It's over. Lonely.
You
you're
are
lonely.
Nobody.
You're lonely.
Your show's gonna get canceled.
You're lonely.
Oh, jeez.
You're lonely. Yeah, your show. Oh, wait. You don't have one.
Oh! Nailed it.
Sorry.
Poland Spring.
When does
be from
when does Peace, Love, and Rock and Roll come out?
June 30th.
Nice. I can't wait. I did a show in L.A. when I was in L.A., too. It's going to be out in the fall.
What was it called?
It's called This Is Not Happening with Ari Shaffir. Yeah. You would have known if we met up and hung out. Yeah. Aaron's on it, too.
I hung out with fucking... you know, I wasn't on it.
Yeah, because you were busy with Marin and Schumer and whoever else.
I don't understand. Everybody, Tom Papa was on the fucking
twice,
show.
Twice, both seasons, two seasons. Two
and he would never puts me on the fucking thing.
I think I know why.
Hey, you were on that show.
He told me not to tell me, but he said, he's like, I like Bobby and he's a sweet guy, but God, is he unfunny. That's what Ari said. but I don't know. I mean, you know, he's crazy. But yeah, check out Aaron and
why
I.
Why did I check not see that?
I really did great on that
I did not see that coming.
What's crazy, too, is like I'm not even friends with Ari. He's just like, you're a fucking genius. Yeah, I need to have you on. He's fucking nuts. But
he never told the story before. He just winged it.
Yeah.
I told it once.
What was the story?
I was like, I can make up
the story,
a story.
I started
about this
to
thing.
Tell it here on the podcast.
What
but
was
a
it?
Crazy chick in Everett.
Don't give it away. It's going to be on the
air. Oh, we did hear it.
No, no. We talked about it. The crazy chick showed up and she blew everybody and had sex, too. I put a bunch of punchlines in there. But here's what happened.
Did you shower before she blew everybody?
I did not, no. Okay. Well, we have multiple stories of a girl showing up and blowing everybody. It was a crazy house in Everett.
I shower before I have sex with my wife.
Why?
Because
you just turned Jewish.
My wife.
Because I shower before I have sex with my wife because I want to fucking...
The cat from He-Man?
Because she ties you up and beats you?
No,
my
because
wife.
I fucking... No. I want to... I don't want... I want to smell good. I want to... I want smelling good. You ever fuck a girl that her breath is great and she smells great? I mean, I'm just not into, like, I fucked a girl once, her armpits stunk.
Yeah,
and
I like
she
that.
Was fucking,
yeah, I'm with
I
you.
Don't
I like
fucking
that.
Like
a little
that.
Musk, a little mustiness?
I think, no.
Yeah. I think women like the smell of mustiness on some men. Yeah.
Musk.
Yes, they do.
It's musky.
It,
musk.
I fucking, nice I stick Christina's face in my armpits like that. She loves
first
it.
First of all, it's not
pheromones.
Farrah Fawcett moans.
Pheromones come out of your butthole. Okay.
That's not true.
Absolutely true.
That's not true.
You do. It comes out of your
doo-doo.
Asshole.
Look.
There's a fucking, your prostate gland, the male G-spot.
I don't think that's actually true.
It's absolutely true.
You fart
look it
pheromones?
Up. Look it up.
You're
no,
a fucking
it's
moron.
A fucking, it's an oil that comes out
not
that
true.
Attracts fucking
I
the
bet
female.
You pheromones are in the sweat.
Look
it's
it up.
In, it's in all body
it's not
fluids.
In sweat. It is not in sweat. It's a gland, you fucking moron. And dogs
how much
have it.
$20.
Why do you think dogs smell each other's assholes?
Yes, dog
they're
pheromones.
It's a different
Bobby.
Species.
They also sweat out of their fucking tongues.
They also bark.
Yeah.
And they have pink dog dicks.
That's why. I'm telling you, it's a fucking
more
fact.
Differences, Joe. Name more differences.
It's a fact.
$20.
It's a fact.
Bobby will bet.
Pheromones don't come out of your asshole. I don't even think pheromones are a real thing. I think that's like a thing.
Pheromones
are
a
real
thing. Well,
wait
a minute. I'm not going to bet that. They might be fake.
Pheromones
but I am going to bet they come out of your asshole if they
$20,
do
$20, the pheromones will come out of your
don't
asshole.
Don't say it yet, Scopo. They haven't shaken hands yet.
A lot of people
think that they come out of your fingers. Ew.
Make the bet. Make the
come
bet.
Come on, $20. You got it right on the table,
I don't,
bitch.
Hang on one second. All right. I don't like fucking dirtiness. I don't like smell. I don't like it.
No, nobody likes dirtiness.
I don't
I'm
like
just
smell.
Saying,
I don't like a smelly
pussy. There was a lot of blue material in your last special, sir.
I don't like
you're,
smelly pussy.
You're in the minority here. You are.
Scopo, do you like smelly pussy?
Nobody's saying
that. No, smelly not pussy. Smelly pussy.
Nobody
smelly
wants
I'm
a
saying
smelly
a man
pussy.
Can right, smell.
Can you not
as
talk
man,
the fuck over each other? Jesus. What I'm saying is this.
What are you saying, Bobby?
There's a fucking smelly pussy is smelly pussy.
Right, that's
no,
gross.
We're
so,
talking
yeah,
about armpits.
Armpits are fine.
I don't like a smelly armpit.
I like
I don't,
armpits.
Why do you like a smelly armpit?
It's real. Keeps it real.
What the fuck does that mean?
It's
well,
just,
you're not a rapper. Really, what does it mean?
I don't know. Something feels good about it.
What doesn't feel anything?
It gets
you're smelling
his dick
dirty.
It feels
yeah.
dirty.
If
dirty
I fuck armpit. A chick and she has a little bit of a musk because she does,
yeah.
that kind of turns me on a
no,
little bit.
No, it's not just because she does. It's because she smells. Because she didn't shower. Because she needs to fucking clean.
No, she...
You know,
no,
just,
what if she
just
went
because
to the gym?
She does.
What if she went to the
yeah,
gym?
gym. Exactly.
She smells.
Yeah, she cares about her body.
Yeah, because she smells.
But here's the thing,
Bobby, a gym is a place where you go and work out.
Yeah, well, hey, fatty, you'll fucking be where I'm at very soon. Trust me. When it all comes tumbling down and the fucking people beneath you past you.
You're saying Lewis is going to be on a show that no one really watches?
Exactly. I can't wait for your next fat. Your next fat is going to be celebrated.
Already here.
I beat him in a push-up contest.
When your next fat.
Through these biker shorts.
I can't wait till your next fat. It's going to be glorious.
I can't wait till your next skinny, which is never going
to
happen.
Really? I will fucking be skinny for your next fat. That will be my gift to you. This is my fucking night. I'm going to come out of a cake that you'll eat.
Let's all get skinny. Bob, I beat Lewis in a push-up contest. Tell him, Lou.
So did everybody.
Yeah, I did. First of all, I had done push-ups in a long time. Okay, and Joe weighs 84 pounds. So if I weighed 84 pounds, I could do 150 push-ups in a row.
Yeah, but you can't get down to 180 pounds.
How many did you do, Joe?
I did 42, and I decided to stop because I was bored.
You didn't decide to stop. Your fucking faggot arms gave out. And I did 27.
Sir,
yes.
Do you like a smelly
Tyler.
Girl?
What, like, no, I don't want a pussy
what about
smells
you?
Like a tire fire.
You didn't even let him answer.
No, because he said no, and I get it. What about
no,
you?
I agree with everything you said, the armpits, everything, because I've been with a woman that has smelled from every part on one occasion.
He put
another,
woman in quotations, by the way.
I like when Lewis gets going. He's out of his pun mode.
Yeah. It's actually my first time seeing it, but yeah, it is nice.
I just don't get it, dude. And a smelly pussy to me is just fucking.
That's disgusting.
Listen, here's the thing.
Yeah, but to have when you're the juice, the asshole juice and the pussy juice, and it mixes, and it's like, ugh, fucking take a shower. If you have the option, if there's a fucking shower, and I'm a grown human
before
being, and
you
I have
fuck, it takes all the romance out of it, Bob.
Does not.
Yes, it
jump,
does.
Jump back. Tell
or
you what,
you're fucking the shower.
Jump. They can't. It's fucking terrible.
Well,
women,
you,
don't
you
like
can't.
Women don't like it. Women don't like it.
They do.
Don't? No, they don't.
Lauren, do you
your
like
pussy?
It?
Yes.
No, you don't. Her pussy's massively huge, so anything can just get in.
She has a fucking underground pool.
I can't fuck in the shower.
What does she have?
Just give me the fucking bandana.
Listen.
I get distracted by the water.
When the water, when it gets in the pussy, dries it out. It's like fucking in a pool. It's hard
that
to do.
That is true.
You think, said yes, but now when I inform her that it stinks.
But like not in the pool.
And it depends on how turned on you are, because I fucked in a pool before, and if the girl's really turned on, it still works. She's got to get your dick in there.
Whose pool was it?
A bunch of pools.
Public pool in
bunch
Harlem.
Of pools.
Yeah, pool hopping with James. Come on, jump the fence.
That's not true.
No, I know for a fact Lewis has never had sex with James. I'm 100% sure.
This is Lewis's new thing. That's not true. Your joke's not true. Go fuck yourself.
I'm gay.
Yes, we know.
Wait, hold on. Human sex pheromones are naturally chemical sense that the body produces in order to attract others.
Where do they come from? Natural sense. Yeah, they're not from your asshole, Bob.
Where they
you're not
from?
A fucking skunk spraying it out of your ass.
Don't say it to me.
It's
like
in your
I'm supposed
sweat.
To just agree with you because you're aggressively telling me something, and that's a fact.
Do you know how great my pheromones would be if it was just out of your ass?
Can you leave?
Wow.
Can you just leave?
Wow.
Fucking thing.
That joke stunk worse than my asshole ever has.
Like
where are they from? Focus.
From the asshole.
It
no,
says
where
it.
Does it say that?
It says it. Read it. Thank you.
Where? Where does it say it, Lauren?
She's well, getting it. Relax,
get it.
You fucking idiot.
Jeez.
Yeah, settle the fuck down.
Tempers
she's getting
are flaring.
It.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to fucking throw a fucking Death Squad fucking kitty at
is
you.
That a Death Squad kitty?
Yeah. If it took your eye out, then you get a patch.
Lewis gets huge because he's a patch.
Patch and a bald head. Just to make all the pirate movies.
Oh, boy.
Anyways.
How come you owe me $50 and you have a pile of cash and it's not in my pocket? What's going on there?
Because I told you. I was trying to tell the story earlier, but you guys fucking went on to some other subject.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought it was your show.
So I was going to buy these chairs, and I left the house without my wallet.
So
I have no money. I had no gas. I had no money. I had nothing.
You said money twice.
I had no money, gas, or money, and I fucking tried to get money. And
they're all signs of a lying a story
it's
that's
not
lying.
True. And then,
well, why don't you just hand him $50 and have Dawn and I write the check?
What does that mean?
Because he owes me $800. That's why.
Now it's $800. You're getting your money, and the game's over. Your little fucking
but
running
dude,
joke.
But here's the thing: there's more money than you even realize.
Why?
You owe me money from other things.
What?
Other things.
What?
Collecting. Yeah.
What?
I don't want to bring it up on air because you'll be like this dude. Don't fucking make it seem like I'm some sort of douche on air. You talk to me in private. You fucking faggot.
Now I'm very interested.
I want to know
a lot of things.
What is it?
A lot of things. It's a collection. It's crazy. It's crazy. Can you think of any? There's a bunch. You owe me like $1,000. I'm not kidding. Bobby owes me close to $1,000.
Besides the other stuff?
T-shirts.
Yeah.
Spot.
Food. I owe you for the spot 50.
We were working on a TV show. You're like, dude, download this thing. I'll pay for half of it.
What was it?
It was fucking some bullshit. Some TV thing.
Oh, you mean...
Celtics. No, the other one.
Celtics free.
Final draft.
Final draft.
Oh, final draft. You're like, I'm like... It's $200. I got no money. You're like, dude, I'll split it with you. I'll write you a check. And then you PayPal. I never got the PayPal.
No. It's like $250.
It was a bullshit.
I don't. I sent you a PayPal. Hang on a second. Stop.
$150 because I was going to buy it yesterday.
Stop.
And I didn't get it.
Stop.
Didn't get it.
First of all, the fact that I have to tell a comedian who I'm writing a show with to get final draft. This guy, let's write something. And I'm like, well, you have to have final draft to write something. I do. What is it? And I'm like, oh,
you know what final draft is?
He doesn't have final draft. He's got more money than me in his fucking savings because I got a kid in a house and a fucking mortgage, and he has a one bedroom, and he splits it with his fucking chick. Okay?
But at the time,
in
I had
Queens,
four roommates.
He has fucking $900 million in the bank, yet I got to fucking half it with him on final draft.
Hold on.
And
if
then,
you said
wait.
But if you said it.
Okay, but wait.
But if you said it.
Okay.
Here, but if you said it.
You
volunteered.
I'm going
to fucking butt you in the head
but
with this
you said it.
Fucking microphone. I sent him through PayPal the fucking money that he never collected.
It didn't work. It didn't work.
But
I don't know how to use PayPal.
Tell me.
I did tell you.
You didn't tell me.
I told.
Hold on, by the way, that's Bobby. Only $75 that he owes you.
Yeah.
No, it was $200. It was $200.
But he said half, right?
Which is 100. Dumb.
Okay, so there's 100. What else?
All right, there's 100. There was another event. That you hired before.
The fact that I have to.
I did a bunch of work.
So why'd you
money?
Have him write a fucking script with you? He's not even a good script writer.
What?
I didn't know that until
I'm
he didn't have final draft.
Ask Dan Soder.
We have great scripts.
You sit there and yell at Dan. Write that down.
That's not true. I shadow box and I intimidate him.
Yeah.
All right. Troy, you're a faggot. Bob, I know. That's the whole script. Our scripts are good.
All right,
our scripts are good.
What else?
What was your script about? I want to know what your script is about.
A certain roast. Remember a roast? This is like 10 years ago.
Yeah.
I wrote, never got paid.
What was that? How much?
$100.
You wrote a set? You wrote a set for a roast?
I wrote a couple jokes.
He gave me a couple jokes.
Did
I use any?
Yeah, I think you did.
Did I or didn't I?
I paid Joe when he helped me write for the Big J roast.
I got paid right away. Appreciate that, Doug. Beautiful.
Brother, I would never try to take advantage of you.
I appreciate that. So what else?
You
what
can't
else?
Let it go this long.
That's it.
Aaron.
It's part of your fault, Joe.
He's a bully. I'm afraid of him.
Say it. Say it.
If someone fucking owes me money, it's that fucking week. That's what you deal with. It. Don't let it muscles out. Unless you want to pull the vig on him, then... It's like, okay, you owe me this plus this.
Guys,
you owed you money. You should have been after him right away.
What were you saying?
Collecting money is like the first 48. You got your best chance of collecting it in the first 48 hours.
Right.
It's like finding a missing person.
Well, I come from a certain place. I thought you were from a similar town.
Boston,
but I owe people. I go, hey,
Fagsville.
I owe you.
You can't trust these grubby selfies.
I owe you money. Here's the money. Boom. Hey,
you're absolutely right. It's like I have a lot going on. If you
Bobby's
say to me,
busy dude.
If you say to me, hey, dude, I need that money, I have
Tell
it for
me
you.
The money. Right away.
I don't need the money. Here's the thing. I don't need the money. You seem to need... If you...
Oh!
Bobby is poor!
Bobby is poor!
Bobby is poor!
What are you going to do? What are you going to do? You know what I mean? I'll work a little harder. I'll do a few extra sets because you got to... If you...
Oh!
You got to keep money. We're up to... What is it? So it's $370 for the T-shirts.
It's not 370, dude. It's fucking 200.
And then you said you're going to pay me half of my computer. That's 600.
Yeah. I think Joe's just bad at math.
Do you see what I'm dealing with? Do you see what I mean? He does this all the time, and then he fucking brings it up 7 years later and goes, what the fuck?
I feel more comfortable with
you
now.
You know what you are? You're a resentment. Hello? You hold resentments. I'm going to need this money to buy this microphone.
Resentment bully.
Give him $250 today. Call it square.
No resentments.
No, I'm going to pay you every... fucking dime.
Oh, that's really sweet of you.
Bob,
that's really nice of you.
You got to settle with him. Like, the creditors just offer him like 60% of it. Be like, are we even then?
Yeah.
Because he'll take it.
I'll take a
cigar.
He
will take it.
I'm going to give you.
Tell you what, you have me on your podcast every once in a while.
I'll
make it much, much better.
I'm going to pay you every red fucking nickel.
I prefer silver.
Red
penny. Those nickels would be covered in blood.
I'm paying you every. I'm gonna drop a check at your. At my kid's birthday, I'm gonna sacrifice one of Max's toys. I'm gonna fucking not get, and I'm gonna stick
you're
it in your pocket.
Buying him $1,000 toys.
Yeah.
Oh, Max. Yeah.
What are you getting him a car?
Hey, do you, yeah, I do. I have an old car. Do you want to give it to James?
Bro, no. Fuck James.
Oh, you want it?
I kind of want the car.
He'll take it to gigs.
No, listen, it's fine.
Listen.
It's fine. I get it, dude. All right, listen. I get it. If I had a younger comic that looked up to me, I wouldn't pay him either. I'd just be like, hey, dude. Well,
I had one.
I want to know what the script was about.
Oh, it's fucking hilarious.
Can we tell them? Should we tell them?
Yeah.
No, it's still out there.
No,
I still want to finish it,
nobody's
bro.
It's not even finished.
But yeah, we stopped.
No, we actually, no. We
finished one.
We finished one.
And we started a second
one. And then
one.
We literally started from scratch. Because we finished the script. We did all the characters. We did everything. And then we looked at it. We were like, this is it would take a lot to produce this. A lot of money to. And the way TV is.
Action hero movie starts with a helicopter shot?
No, it's just the way that it was on a train. It was on a train. So you'd have to have. Shit going by the windows.
It was about Jews.
The whole time. It was just.
Jews on a train?
Production-wise, it would have been fucking ridiculous. So
we wrote a better one.
And now, because back in the day, TV would actually pay for that. But
this
now, it's just a one-camera shoot. A lot of these shows that hit, and it cost way less to shoot. So we wrote a better one.
We should take it to Louis. You're friends with Louis.
I'm not interested.
I'm friends with.
Why don't we finish? Why don't we do this?
That was classic.
Why don't we do this? Sunday, you come over.
He has so few. Can we acknowledge when he gets one? For God's sakes. I mean, yes. We should throwing
everybody,
him a party.
Everybody, applause for Lewis.
Yay.
I mean, we should be getting him gifts.
I want a nice 20-second applause.
Yeah,
20 seconds is longer
it
than you think.
It wasn't that good, though, for that.
20 seconds is longer than you think.
Joe, can I hear more of Lewis's script? I really like that.
Can we? We'll take it to Louis. You're friends with Louis. I'm friends with Louis.
Yeah.
We got a show.
Yeah.
Huh?
Okay, well, yeah, let's take it to Louis, the guy who has 9 shows on TV right now.
Why can't he have 10? Lucky 10. Lucky Louis 10.
Yeah.
I hate myself. Well, I think I'm not performing well
today. Why don't I pay you first, get you off my fucking grind?
Yeah.
Okay, so
I haven't really been grinding, bringing up that money you've owed me for 2 years once.
So why don't I get you off my fucking, get you off me?
Do it
so
now.
I don't have to worry about it. I don't have the paycheck.
Don't write a check. Call her up right now. Yeah. Get her to write a check
just
right
give
now.
Give him the cash.
How much is it?
$50. I want the $50 that you promised
me
a week ago.
Up.
Everything else is
how much you want?
Too far gone.
How much you want?
It's past.
How much you want?
So 100? No, I got it. 100 for the fucking final draft.
100 for the
fucking. 50 for
I'm
the
gonna
thing.
Pay.
He's gotta have Louis do it.
Hang on 1 second. Can I say something, Louis? Are you representing him?
I'm representing. Right,
okay.
Joe. I'm his financial advisor.
You're getting 10%, bro.
270.
10%.
10%. Love it. Thank you, brother. 270 plus 100.
I would like to say
plus
this.
Plus 50.
Stop. Can I?
Plus 100 for the roast. And
can
that's
I say,
it.
Can I say
$520. I don't need a calculator.
He's a human calculator.
Jesus.
I owe you $52, bro. I'll pay it to you immediately.
I would like to.
$52
can
right
I
now.
Say something to your fucking client? The $100
to me. I'll tell him.
The $100 for the final draft. If we sell, if
got
we,
if you sell,
if we sell the show,
if you sell the show,
got it.
If we ever make the show, he has to pay me that money back.
Done deal.
Ooh.
Shut up, Joe.
I'll pay.
Joe, shut the fuck up. Sorry. Tell me. I'll tell you. Not a deal.
Then I'm not doing it.
Are you crazy? You owe him the money.
No, I don't.
We don't need. Hold on.
We don't finish the show.
We don't.
Then
need,
I don't finish
that's
the show.
The show's
I'll
out the
triple
window.
It.
Nobody's buying the show. Louis hates you.
Listen.
Look
we
at.
We're not doing
I'm
the show.
I'm representing Kelly now. Here's
Thank
what's
you.
Gonna happen.
Kelly Fastuca.
Look. The deal is.
Hello, Bobby.
No deal.
Bobby.
If
I got a one-man show, Bobby. It's selling out. There's only 4 seats in Melbourne.
Do you understand, though, the running gag of you being a deadbeat is worth more than 500? It's worth more
check.
Than $500 to
write
me.
Write him a check for $350. Call
no,
it done.
$520 and not a fucking
Take
penny
fucking
less.
Take fucking $350 and
I will
done.
Pay him $520 if
he
I get that 100
back. $520.
Fine. If it goes to series, not a pilot. If it
you
goes
give
to
give him the 100
podcast,
back.
No, you, know what you get for a pilot? Do you even know?
Pilot definitely.
Not
is.
Today,
money
dude.
Back.
This isn't fucking 95.
Nah, it's gotta
right?
get
this green is 2016.
Lit. Gotta get green
Buddy,
lit for
you'll
13.
Barely have enough money for production.
Can I ask you a question?
No,
he
for me.
He
me.
Literally, he just said, not today's pilots. Like pilots, the money stayed the same as it was.
Joe,
back
I don't
in the
know
day.
Anything that I'm talking about.
But if it was like streaming or something cheaper than that, then you could make a pilot for way cheaper.
If
that's
it goes
important.
To series,
yeah. No.
He'll pay
I
you back. How about,
will you tell
can
will
I,
you
can
tell,
I counter?
I'm not
can
talking,
I counter?
I am not talking
Let
to you
me
directly
listen
anymore.
To the offer, Bobby.
Go.
Where's the gavel?
How about this? If it goes to series,
yep.
Joe will pay for final draft himself, altogether, $200 back, but nothing if it just goes to pilot.
$350 and that deal.
No, $350. He's getting the $520.
But we settle it today. this money.
Order in
be
the court. Order
money.
In the court. Look at me. I need
well, you
to
can't
to
be
you.
The judge and the client.
I need a moment with my client.
Did you pay for these
please?
Microphones and this mixing board?
I need a moment with
Let Tyler be the judge because I don't trust anybody else in the room.
All right, Tyler.
Yeah, take a 2-minute commercial recess while I
here.
Speak.
You have to suck the dick first before you to be your honorary judge. You have to put it in your mouth. Seriously, will you do like this. Kiss it.
Just kiss it.
Like that, and then go, ooh, I love it.
Ooh.
I love it.
Right. And then you gotta go order in my butt.
where the pheromones come from.
No, ready? Yep.
Wait, stop. Pause.
Let's pause in the
read
trial.
Read it.
Underarms, the nipples of
underarms.
Both sexes, the public genital and
pubic.
Yeah, genital areas. Yeah.
Wait.
The lips,
yep. The eyelids, and the outer ear.
No anus?
No
anus.
Ass, you
not
fucking
even ass,
fucking
is it?
Fuck.
Everything
fuck.
But the asshole.
All right.
Lewis is smarter than Bobby.
I like that you'll pay Lewis before you pay him.
That's because these bullies look out for each other.
In light of this new evidence, we're willing to counter-offer $330, subtracting the $20.
Lewis sees money. It's like a goat at the zoo.
Lewis, that 20 goes towards the 52 I owe you.
That's like what I said.
No way.
What are you talking about? That's fair.
No
Give
way.
Give him $320 today. It's even.
All right, listen.
No, all right.
Joe's getting married. He needs the money.
$420, and we're even. No payment back on
$420.
$420.
And we'll smoke a joint in celebration,
bro. Wait a minute.
Bro.
The T-shirts is my physical money. That's not even fucking.
Joe,
buddy.
Joe, less
buddy,
talk,
first of all, that
more
was my guy.
Money.
I set it up. What do I get
no,
paid for setting it up?
No, you can't do that. What?
What
you're
do I get for setting
from the
it up?
Lewis school all
what
of a sudden.
What do I get for setting it up?
There's no setting it up.
See how we treat you?
They're my shirts. You took
$220.
Them. You asked them for me. $220.
First, that's a lie.
Your Honor,
that's a lie. I want to speak.
Take the deal. $220, you just said it.
That is a lie. You came to me, sir. You came to me, sir, and said, Bob, a fan gave me the shirt. Can I please put them up on yours?
Incorrect.
Can you
That's
please?
Fucking crazy.
And I said, I will do it. And
see,
you
now
said,
I don't
please,
know if you're
sir.
Trying to get me mad or not.
Dude.
That's insane. You volunteered.
All,
you're like, give them to
when
me.
When Joe gets
I'll
mad,
sell
he just starts making the sound of a tea kettle.
I like the joke. Your laugh's hurting my feelings.
Shit.
All I want is the 50 from last week. We'll call it a thing.
Bobby, give him $50.
We'll call it even. You can keep my other 800.
Give him $50.
You need it more than I do.
I think both should just blow each other.
Joe.
I'll suck anyone's dick in here for fun.
Right now, call Dawn. Right. Check for $400 completely even. Wipe the slate clean.
Give him $50.
Check for $400.
I don't want it. Shut
up. Joe, shut the fuck up.
Joe, take it.
Shut up, Joe.
I won't take it.
Are we done? Are we done?
What do you mean?
I'm done with you.
As friends?
What?
I'm done with you.
In L.A. and New York?
He's coming down.
That sounded like your career.
Yeah, that's the sound of you milking that dumb bitch.
All right. Well, Joe, this Sunday at the party, you will be taken care of in full, my friend.
Yeah. Sexually.
I'm not going to be there, but...
Are you not coming?
I'm going to try. I land at
3:10. John Stamos isn't there, so...
What party's this? So, you know you're invited to my wedding, right?
I guess you're coming.
Yeah, all right.
you're definitely not coming.
Will Schumer, Louis, or at least Opie be there? I need somebody that can help
out. Am I allowed to sit at the big boy table this year?
Here's the thing, and can I say this? Because you're not the only person that has confronted me with this. Other people, civilians, have said it, too, about having, like, Colin and Amy and Keith and blah, 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 that table.
Wait, people who aren't police officers or military?
So, no, please don't give it to him. Don't give it. That was too bad. I don't want it near him. Oh, I just farted. What up? You understand, I'm running the party.
Oh, pheromones.
I'm getting horny right now. Every time Bobby farts, it just blows right in my face.
It is so rare that Lewis is the funniest guy on the show.
He really is killing it today. Mm-hmm. Here's the deal. I am running the party. I'm cooking the food. I'm doing a lot. I'm not just hanging out. I'm doing a lot of shit. So
you need a couple bucks to borrow?
I can't make sure your fucking social skills are up to par.
No, you put us at...
Buddy, I didn't. Did not.
Other table.
You sat there. I did
no,
not
I
tell
didn't.
You where to sit.
I swear to God.
Did
I
tell you where to sit?
Kind of.
No, I did not. I never
wish
did
we could
that.
Go back in time with like video footage.
Buddy,
did sit there.
I did never said that.
Away from Schumer.
I set up the fucking tables, and Schumer and Colin and Keith, you guys all just went and sat where you sat. Bailey sat with her husband over here. My neighbor sat here. Everybody just went and did their thing. I would never tell anybody to sit anywhere. It is up to fucking... You know who went over to the other table? Dan Soda. Got up, left you guys, and went and sat. Well, your fucking... Your shit self-esteem kept you at that fucking table. You should have walked over and sat next to Quinn and went, "What's up, dude? I'm Lou. Hey, yeah, I know you." And hung the fuck out. That's it. Because I had other people go, "Dude, all the comics kind of sit together and you feel kind of... Hey, man, that's not my fucking problem. You're a civilian. Walk up and say hi. They're right there."
Yeah.
I'm cooking fucking 500 steak tips, 300 hamburgers, and fucking 900 sausages.
And that's just for Bobby.
Right?
Are we getting steak tips this year?
Yes, I'm ordering them. They're being fucking driven in from Boston on Saturday.
You know what? I don't want to sit at the big boy table.
You sit wherever you want.
I'm
going to
stay
with me.
Me and my kid are going to fucking sit at our own little table.
We got a fun thing for the kids this
year. I know, you told me.
We have
a hot fucking chick.
Face painting.
Subway sandwiches. Jared Fogle's bringing them.
I would like you to shave the day of the party.
What do you mean?
I have a face painter, and she's going to give you a fucking mouth and a chin.
Robert, I feel like you're being very insensitive.
We got face painting, balloon animals.
Flames, like Bam Bam Bigelow.
That's actually a pretty good idea. Balloon animals.
Very great Halloween costume for you.
Dawn's making all these punch things. We got the whole fence is going to be papered so the kids can go up and paint it.
Can you get O'Doul's?
I'm
on an O'Doul's kick.
Yeah, you could. Yeah. I got some O'Doul's for you. Yeah, sure.
So the
kid's going to be, and we have a lady who's going to kind of corral the kids. Make sure.
Short tits.
I'll corral the kids.
Huh?
I'll corral the kids.
Well, you can, yeah. She's great. You're coming too, yeah. So it's going to be a fun party. You know.
I'll be a little driving. Late. Are you driving, Scopo?
I am driving.
Scopo,
yeah.
Can you give me a ride?
I got to be there probably like at 10 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, wait. Yeah. There's a train goes right there, right?
White Plains, you take a cab. It's a $5 ride.
Can you pick me up from the train?
I can pick
you
up from the train.
Sweet.
Yeah, there you go.
Bring car seat, though.
No, he's fucking 3.5.
We're going to put him
right booster. Bring a booster.
Okay.
Well, you can just take my car.
Bobby, how late can I be? I land at 3:10 p.m.
Just come right to the party.
From where?
LaGuardia?
Yeah.
Yeah, you'll be
what
half
time
hour.
What
takes
time
a half
does it
hour.
Start?
It takes a half hour to get there. Starts at 2 o'clock.
You're going
to
take a cab
you started like
LaGuardia?
An hour earlier? I guess. I got to
pick me up and I'll go with you and split it.
All right, I got to go home get rid of
Just come for a couple hours. It's going to be a good party, man. It's
going to
be a lot of fun.
How late does it go till?
It goes till 6 o'clock.
Who's going to be the most famous person there?
Colin Quinn.
Really?
Yeah.
Amy's way more famous.
I don't think Amy's coming.
Oh.
I invited her. I mean, she's welcome to come, but you never know, you know?
Famous for the party now?
No, she might not be around. She might be fucking doing shows somewhere.
What about Louie? We could pitch the show.
I told Louie to come. And he said,
he texted back, who's this?
He said, I don't know. So I texted him, you know, I said, I'll send it to him the night of.
I'll call. I'll feel him out.
Yeah. So, look it. Dan's going to be there. You're going to be there.
Norton?
Huh?
Norton?
Norton's coming.
Love Norton.
So my core friends are going to be there. There's a group of people that I want to come. Like Serpico's not coming. I was bummed out about that. But he can't make it, you know.
Opie?
I invited Opie. I don't know if he's coming.
John Corbett?
John Corbett is not coming.
Dennis Leary?
Liz Gillies?
Liz Gillies?
No.
I went to Elaine?
How about this, though? I went to Liz Gillies' house in L.A.,
there's a picture of her with
what?
Sinuses weren't hurting too bad that day, were they? You fuck, what'd you wear? Your Breathe Right nose strip? So you go to fucking Liz Gillies' house? Unbelievably hurt.
Buddy.
Keep your money. All I want is a little fucking a text back. I want to fucking have a cigar, dude. Let's have a cigar after this.
Okay, you want to go with, what's your name?
Yeah. I'll go.
And
I'll go.
We'll go with Andre.
Yes. Let's have some cigars.
We'll go with
Aaron.
We're gonna know.
Andre is such a better name for him.
It's Andre.
Andre Berg.
It's Andre steroids.
Hello, bonjour. I'm Andre.
All right, so yeah, I'll definitely smoke.
Let's go have to smoke some bats.
That's cool.
Go back to Liz Gillies.
Yeah, we went to her house.
You can see her tits in a picture, like
who's
online.
Liz Gillies.
What?
You can see her tits.
Dude, we were there.
It's like a see-through top she's wearing on some shit.
Let's go to Books and Bars right down the street.
I want to hear more about Liz.
Sorry. Liz Gillies is beautiful. I went to her house the night.
She's no Lauren.
The night of. Can I tell the fucking story?
Well, she's fucking blowing kisses.
I'm fucking right here. She's not blowing them to you. She's blowing them to him.
I know, but don't yell at me like it's my fault.
Yeah, but
she
it's
just
not.
Went, thanks, Lou, and blew a kiss. And you're yelling at me. Yell at these two fucking
knuckleheads. Can we get back to Liz? Come
on. You might
on.
Have a chance.
Let this love bloom.
Oh, I'm
Lewis,
done.
Girlfriend.
Make a move.
Tell the story. Good. Keep the mic away, silly.
Lewis, make a
be
move.
Joe, can you not do my move?
Make a move, Lewis.
Is Joe a hack for stealing Lewis's move?
All right, you shut up. You shut the fuck up. You shut the fuck up. All and right. Please, for the love of God, Joe, shut the fuck up.
You got it.
All right, let's go to the chat room real quick. What do we got in there, Depot?
Sure. Buddy C. Buddy says, Tuesdays with audits.
I liked it. Fuck off.
Christ Killer says, Bobby's confusing pheromones with Dane Cook's cum.
Oh!
That's not bad.
Not bad. That was good. Really good. That was that was a good one.
He also says, I'm sure there's closed-circuit TV footage of Lewis fucking somewhere.
Is there footage of me fucking?
Like security cam footage.
Yeah, definitely. Oh, yeah. Milano's bar on Houston Street.
Yeah, security footage, 100%.
Yeah.
A Walmart children's fitting room.
He thought you meant Comedy Central TV. That's why he was so shocked.
Daily Dose says, I got a sweet pickup line for Berg. Baby, you must be Hebrew because Jew sexy.
Can you block that guy from the room?
No, I don't think it's that bad. I just didn't know why he didn't.
Why'd you do the voice?
Went with instinct there.
He did a voice.
Yeah, Aaron's voice is deep.
That kind of sounds like Berg. Hey, how's it going, guys?
What? I think you have a deep voice.
This is Willy Wonka?
You have a gravelly voice.
I think I'm nasally but gravelly at the same time.
Yeah, I think it sounds more like this. I can't do impressions.
Hey, I went to Liz's house and her boyfriend.
Who?
She has a boyfriend.
She has a boyfriend, and he's fucking...
He's hot.
Does all the music for, like, the Nickelodeon shows and all those kids' shows.
He's loaded.
He's like a genius musician, all from his house. Surfer kind of dude. He's in his 40s.
Good-looking guy.
Good-looking guy. Really cool guy, but amazing house. Awesome pad. We smoke stogies out in his back. It was she's fucking great, man.
Did she mention me?
No,
no. She actually, I think she brought up soda once.
God damn.
No. I swear to God.
Told us. Yeah.
It's always soda.
I think she said, "Who's that guy?" And I was like, and she,
"I'd fucking kill him."
I swear to God.
If he fucked her, I would fucking kill him.
He'd be like, "I fucked her, but I didn't fuck her well. You would have fucked her better."
She'd be like, "No, you fucked me really good, Dan. Yeah. You really did great.
No,
you're awesome.
No,
you were so much better."
No, she has a boyfriend. She's not fucking anybody. But she looks...
Really, that's the standard?
I have to say that because it's recording.
Okay.
Okay? I have to have a backup.
You record these?
What? No, I don't think so. Maybe. No. I wish she did.
When we were there, she was fixing her tits right into the camera. It was zoomed right in Scopo's face.
Yeah, I got a chubby.
Yeah.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
When's the last time you got a boner in public?
I got
now.
One. I got one the other day.
Didn't
it
just happen?
If I don't jerk off in the morning, I'll get boners all day.
When you're a teenager in 20s. I got one yesterday because I was on the exercise bike at the gym, and I didn't have any like tight underwear on, so my dick was rubbing on the leg. Every time. You can jerk off on a bike because my leg was rubbing up against my business, and I had some important fun sex the night before.
Yeah, if you have a vagina, you can do it. Where's the... Thanks. Wow, I really said that like it was going to kill, didn't I?
Yeah.
I actually had timing in there. I was like, yeah, if you have a vagina, you could do it. Like I was on fucking Just for Laughs gala. Whoa, two in a row. Oh, God. Not even the Canadians like that one.
Boy.
I actually, I had, what was the last time you came in your sleep?
Zero.
I've never done that.
You've never had a night emission?
Years ago. You know when you come in your dream, then you think you come in your... I came in my dream a month ago, woke up thinking, oh, God, I came. No, it was just dream come.
Yeah. I came
it doesn't exist.
Dream what? Come.
I came that was the MLK speech.
I came in my dream.
Yeah.
And I woke up, my underwear was full.
That's what's supposed
really?
To happen.
What?
Like, full, like I've... I came in the dream like I've never... I went... Like I was like a woman coming, and I woke up, my underwear was full, and cum was, as I woke up, jizz was still shooting out.
Yeah,
it was so amazing. It was so, and I wanted to call my wife and be like, honey, well, what are you thinking of? It was fucking, not you.
Yeah.
It was a fucking Indian girl by a stream.
Why by a stream?
The Land O'Lakes lady?
Yeah, the lake broad was by a stream, and there was fucking buffalo behind her. So it was a 2-for-1. But, yeah, I come in, man, what a feeling to come without touching your dick.
Yeah.
Imagine that.
I was reading up on lucid dreaming. And I really want to, like, train myself to lucid dream. That's
what,
like,
I heard that. You can do that. There's things, you, there's exercise you can take to have
so
crazy
basically you
lucid
can control
dreams.
Your dreams. They did it in, like, the Nightmare on Elm Street movies. Like, she was like, you have to learn how to train your dreams so you could fight Freddy. But it's a real thing. And you could basically, you could just go, when you, I did it one time. Like, I was like, I want to dream that I'm on the beach. Because I got really, I saw that movie Waking Life on acid when I was, like, 18 by myself. And I was like, dude, I think that's the coolest thing on earth. And then, like, I went to bed every night for, like, a week thinking I was on a beach. Just imagining a beach, imagining a beach. And then I dreamed that I was at the beach. But lucid dreaming is when you're in your dream and you realize that you're in a dream. And then you can start controlling the fucking shit that's going on in your dream. So you could fly, you could do whatever you want. There's, like, techniques where... when you just, throughout the day, you start knocking on the table, right? You just keep on doing that throughout the day. Just do it all day long. Just knock on the table. And then in the dream, like, you'll start doing that in, like, your dream. And then you realize, it's a way to, like, realize that you're actually dreaming. I was watching these fucking videos and reading these articles about it. But how fucking cool would that be to just be able to control your dreams? You know, just fucking, you go to sleep and you're just like, I'm going to fuck Liz Gillies while I fucking have... just watch Bobby get fucked by a bunch of black guys, like, just fucking.
What the fuck? What happened?
How great would that be?
That would be awful.
Awesome.
And you want to watch me get fucked by black guys?
Hilarious.
While he's fucking Liz Gillies, though.
Yeah.
While you, that's the only thing that keeps you hard. Yeah. You keep looking over and see black cock going in my juicy asshole.
Yeah.
Yeah. Whatever. I'll fucking.
I was talking to.
I don't like that his blood sugar went down, and that's why that joke bombed.
I think you're right.
Or maybe I just bombed.
I was talking to...
This is the worst. Fuck you, Lewis.
You're off today.
I'm not off. What are you doing?
I gotta eat.
What are you eating? What is that, a protein bar?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Oh, shit. That's the price of being in good shape. You have, like, a timer that goes off, and you have to just put protein into your body at that moment.
It'll take a minute. 2 minutes.
Oh, God.
Anyways, well, I think we started talking about this a couple minutes ago or 3 hours ago. You gotta watch Ari's show. It's amazing. I went to the night before to watch a tape and get a feel for it.
Yeah.
I saw Brian Regan, the Chicago guy, Chris Flannery, I think his name is. Most unbelievable story
Sean
I've ever heard. Sean Flannery. Most unbelievable story I've ever heard in my life.
Was that Regan the guy with the long hair?
No, short hair. Scally cap.
Okay.
And then Julia McCullough had an unbelievable fucking story.
Doug Stanhope.
Stanhope.
What was the story?
Amazing.
Joe List.
There's Chris, the Sean Flannery story. Aaron Berg.
Yeah.
So what'd you go? You got a story and just made it into a joke.
It's a long, you tell a story. I added jokes too, or punched it up a little bit. But here's what I did. I went to the show the night before.
Right.
And I fucking couldn't sleep. Going back to sleep, I tossed and turned the whole night because these guys were so good. Everyone fucking, it was Regan, Julian McCullough, this guy Alik.
How long was it the stories?
As long as you want, but mostly 10 to 15, 10 to 20. But these guys were so
good.
10
to 20 minute story?
Ali Sadiq.
Most people
Ali
did
Sadiq.
Like 12 to 15.
Yeah.
I've watched every one of Joey Diaz's stories on it. He's the fucking best storyteller in the world.
Russell Peters did like 40 minutes.
What?
Really?
Yeah, he just went crazy. But it was pretty unbelievable. Everyone was so good. I couldn't sleep because I was like, I'm fucked. I got nothing. I'm an idiot. I'm telling some bullshit, dumb story.
I can't even believe I didn't even get fucking asked to do it.
No, I can believe it.
No, I'm serious.
Yeah, you're an okay comic, but your storytelling isn't that great.
But you're
I'm
pretty
serious.
Good at hosting a podcast.
I can't fucking believe it. I love Ari. I love him.
But did you ask him to do the show?
Last time he actually told me, he goes, they wanted more diversity. They didn't want a bunch of one. Now, this time it seems like everybody and their fucking mother did it.
No, they diversed it up. They had Stanhope, Berg, me, Flannery,
Big
Regan,
J for the third time.
Julie McCullough, Jay Orkison.
No, this time.
Steve Renazzisi.
The last time they wanted, you know, other people, he said.
Right.
So.
No.
Renazzisi made up another story.
I always wind up doing
I
those shows.
I was in one of the planes.
I always wind up doing those dumb shows when they're done. You know what I mean? Like when it's jumped the shark.
Right.
I usually wind up doing that stupid shit.
You should do it next season.
Yeah, whatever.
You know what you're really good at, Bobby?
What?
Eating.
Getting. That was him, not me.
That was a good one. I got it.
I think you're. Well, now my joke is shit. My joke is going to be finding talent to have on your podcast.
He stepped on it. That would have been a great joke.
It was going to be fun.
But he stepped on it with a fat joke.
Yeah, before I could
nice
get to my.
Low hanging fruit. Low hanging donuts, Bobby. I want to make him understand.
Oh, my God. You really went there?
Yeah.
We got it.
Low hanging donuts.
We got it.
Low hanging crispy
I know, but
greens.
Then you explained the joke. because we needed
low-hanging malted shakes.
Dude, let's go settle it all, settle the stages, whatever the saying is. Get some bats, smoke them up.
Let's get some sticks.
Let's go to books and bars.
Let's go have a
and
stick.
Have some have some cigars.
Get some sticks.
Yes.
I'll be home. I got tonight off. I'm going to go home and watch the Mets.
We're only an hour and 10 minutes into the show. We still have another hour of show.
Bobby, you in?
I'm in, but can we finish the show?
You're going to do this thing where you say it, and then you're like, dude, I got a lot going on. I'm fucking gay. I'm crazy. My brother.
Here's what you do, though. You fucking take off right after the show. You're gone.
Let's all go together. Because you can't drive home because it's rush hour. We got nothing.
Yeah.
So we'll hang out.
I got a spot.
Let's go for a stick.
I got nothing going on until 9 o'clock, guys.
You don't smoke cigars.
Yes, I do.
No, you said
before you. Before you smoked cigars and thought it was cool.
Why are you getting mad?
I was doing it.
I know everything. You've done everything before everybody. Why are you flipping out right now?
Because you're making up stories about
me. No, because I did not. I said you don't smoke cigars because you say, dude, you're going to get
mouth
cancer. I can't wait to you. I don't either.
How many do you smoke a day?
I don't either. I smoke one. I smoke 4 weeks.
Sometimes two.
4 a week.
Yeah,
You don't smoke a bat every
day.
Bobby's
dying right now.
I do not smoke a bat every day.
I smoke 2 to 3 cigars a day.
Do not.
You're going to die.
Everyone's going to die, first of all.
You're going to die sooner
second
and with
of
no
all,
mouth on your face.
Second of all, I'll be fine.
It's not that bad.
Because I squat like crazy.
How are you going to do crowd work with no mouth?
Just point and snap my fingers like Sherrod.
That seemed like a joke, but you can't really do stand-up jokes either.
With no mouth.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bobby, you missed a good one. You dazed off. I had a big one, buddy.
What was it?
I feel like we're fighting.
When you come in and you call me a fucking chiseler, you tell me to go fuck myself.
Chiseler.
Yeah, you call me a...
I didn't call you chiseled. I would never call you chiseled.
Somebody who makes statues, chiselers?
He said you're going to die with
a
no
chiseler
mouth.
Is a fucking cheap guy. A fucking guy who...
I don't think that's real.
I've never
absolutely.
Heard of him. Never heard of him.
Yeah, Whitey Bulger.
Urban Dictionary. Urban Dictionary chiseler.
Where do chiselers
fuck
come
you.
From?
Yeah. Send me $20. Send me my $20
I think
back.
You're thinking of
miser. Send me the $20 or shut the fuck up.
No.
Yeah, then I'm right.
That's not the bet. You're too confident.
I think it's...
Chiseler.
Chiseler.
I think it's miser
it's
or kike, stuff like that.
Hey.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, a true A-lister. One who enjoys gambling, women, drinking.
You're just wrong. That's not what a chiseler is.
What a great chiseler.
Yeah, I should have bet.
You should have.
A true A-lister.
That's hilarious.
Drinking and boating.
What is it?
Isn't it spelled
gambling, women, drinking, boating.
Can she do it or you do it? Because I don't need fucking two dummies doing it. I need
it up.
One.
He all right. stepped in.
All right.
A true A-lister, one who enjoys gambling.
We go back and forth.
Women.
I don't like going back and forth.
Why not?
Fat and forth.
A true A-lister who enjoys gambling, women, drinking, boating, and all of the fine things.
I'm a chiseler.
Bobby's
a chiseler. I'm a fucking chiseler.
Oh, I wish you bet. I wish you bet.
Bye. I'm a chiseler. I'm a chiseler.
Yeah, I didn't call you a chiseler. And
you said that I love boating. You did. You said I love all the finer things
in life. I'm an A-lister. I'm sick of it.
Well, it's Bobby Montgomery Kelly over on that 40-footer.
Did you see the fucking... the baby that fell into the gorilla cage?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And no, I just heard about it now. What is it?
Are you kidding me?
No, I was trying to be sarcastic, and it was too stupid and cunty. I'm sorry.
I was saving this for Legion of Skanks because we can make a lot of racist jokes, but go ahead.
Yeah, I know. Why? Because of the baby?
No, because
the gorilla. A
17-year-old gorilla shot in Cincinnati.
Because the guy that got choked in Staten Island was manhandling a baby. All right, give me the band.
Wait, you also
get the racist one, too.
And you get the bomb, Dan.
Yeah, please.
That's the first time it's ever happened. Someone tries to pull it and tie it on there. Like you're Steven Tyler.
But the parents are getting fucking crucified.
I think
they
that's fucked
be.
Up. No, they shouldn't.
They right. should be.
You know who's saying that? People that don't have kids.
Right.
Okay?
Right.
You have a 4-year-old.
Yep.
It's dude, why don't you have your kid's hand? The whole time at a zoo, you think you're holding your 4-year-old's fucking hand? The kid wants to fucking
how about
explore
the fucking zoo makes it so you can't fucking get into the cage?
Yeah.
All right, why? What is this fucking old 60-year-old fucking zoo with a 15-foot drop? Put him behind plexiglass like a new zoo has.
Yeah.
Any kid can jump over and fucking fall off.
And look, yeah, technically, I don't think it's a bad parent that if you take your eyes off your kid, she's got 4 kids with her.
Right.
You take your eyes off your kid for 1 second. A 4-year-old is not a baby.
She
you
can
know
lose
what I'm
one.
A 4-year-old, let me tell you something, though. A 4-year-old's not a baby, but goddamn did it break my heart watching that little kid getting dragged around that
I didn't actually
puddle.
See the baby getting dragged
it's
around.
It's fucking the saddest shit I've ever seen because I have a 3-year-old. You have a 4-year-old.
3.5.
And you see the fucking kid drop off. You know, you see the kid in the puddle, and the gorilla's just holding it.
Yeah.
They say the gorilla was trying to protect it.
He was trying to prop him up at one point.
He was trying to protect it, but it's like, and why the fuck do you got to shoot it? Tranquilize the fucking thing.
Yeah. Well, they said it takes a while for the tranquilizer to set in.
That's what they're saying. Yeah.
So they could have fucking
killed him. At
that
point, the girl's going to pump up his sneakers, and you don't know what's going
to
happen.
I agree with you. I don't
That was a good one.
There's something wrong with you, dude.
What?
There's something wrong with you.
If you don't get that racist show at MTV, they don't know what they're doing.
I tell you, I feel bad for the parents because they're being... The gorilla got shot because these people were assholes. No. What do you... If there's a fucking choice between... There's an accident happens. And there's a choice between killing the gorilla or letting a baby die.
Not only... It's not even like... The gorilla takes one to the fucking head. This baby's going to be beaten to death by a gorilla.
In front of his parents.
Yeah, that's... I mean, look. You got to choose one. The gorilla's going. Peace.
Sorry.
Sorry, buddy. You know, it sucks. The whole thing just sucks. But
yeah, but it's an accident that happened, and now because they're saying because these stupid parents, a beautiful gorilla died. Fuck you. How about this, fuckface? How about we don't have gorillas in cages? Let them just be in the jungle with a fuck.
Or on the streets of Cincinnati.
Yeah, or above 125th.
Gorilla's probably happy he got fucking shot instead of having to dry hump an old fucking tire every day.
Yeah, but you're probably right.
I mean, heard somebody...
You should have fucking had more confidence in that. It would have been funnier, but...
You seen a Planet of the Apes where he runs up to the fucking...
I thought that was
fucking
really good.
You could win bets that way with a lot of confidence.
Yeah.
I think... I heard someone, though, write... My friend Evan wrote a thing about he grew up in a zoo. Like, his dad was a zoo... Keeper, you fucking jackals.
Why are you getting mad at us for you? Because you don't know what a fucking zookeeper is.
Because I fucking said he grew up in a zoo and I was waiting for everyone to go.
Deliver with a little more confidence, right?
Yes, exactly. He grew up, his dad was a zookeeper. And they said these zoos, a lot of times those animals are taken away from places they were getting poached and hunted.
Right.
And they spend all of the budget on a zoo is to recreate that thing. So these animals are actually
being
relatively saved and actually pretty happy. Yeah, but well, it is, I would say...
Okay, fine, but why don't we spend all that money and go fucking protect these gorillas and set up an army that protects the gorillas against these poachers?
That's ridiculous.
I mean, that's... Well,
gorilla. You have an army that goes lives in Africa?
Do you know how much it costs to fucking... Well, to have a zoo and have that cage and to feed it? And
much less than a wig.
If you're saying this, I hope you never... you never go to the zoo, then.
Look...
Ever?
I like
You've never taken your kid to the zoo ever.
I like the zoo, but
you
I
see Bobby up against the glass with the gorilla.
I do feel bad for the.
No, I feel bad too. But if you feel that bad that you're like, how about we don't do this? Then you can't support. You can't give them your money.
Yeah, but I'm saying that the people that are actually saying this poor endangered species had to die because of. Parents
on his birthday, by the way.
Parents,
is that right?
Was it
his birthday?
How do they stop? How the fuck do they know?
I swear to look it up.
He's wearing a party hat.
How do they know it's his birthday?
They had a barbecue and purple drink for him.
All his cousins were there. It was crazy.
My point is this: it's not. I don't think the parents. I don't think it's their fucking fault. I really don't think it's their fault. I don't think that it's. Like you said, I put a fence around my backyard because we'd be talking. Max would be right there, and all of a sudden we'd be talking. And then he'd be on the neighbor's lawn.
Yeah.
And fucking a second, you're like, what the fuck? It's almost like magic. You're like, this can't happen.
Well, you also take him to a zoo, and you're right about that. They shouldn't have it to make it to where a fucking kid could get into the cage. It's like you want
There
your
should
kid.
Be no way
I brought
ever.
My son to the children's museum yesterday, right. Okay? At what point, I'm like one of these parents that's hovering over my kid all the time. I really got to stop doing that shit because I'm going to make him do a pussy. But, like, you let him run around and you let him have fun. You know what I'm saying? When you're bringing a kid to a zoo, they want to run from exhibit to exhibit. You're not going to hold their hand
but,
the whole time you're in a zoo.
But you got to have your eyes on them 100% of the time, right?
Yeah.
I mean, it must take a while to crawl underneath
there
the fucking
should
thing.
Not be a...
I agree
there
with that.
There should be no opportunity for any human being to fall into a fucking
I agree
gorilla
with that.
Pit.
I agree with that. But if you're a kid, if you're out in New York City, let's say, another dangerous place, and the
gorillas
kid...
Gorillas everywhere.
And the kid...
on the train.
And the kid... Your kid's in the middle of 6th Avenue.
Showtime!
And your kid is in the middle of 6th Avenue. Jesus. Bobby?
I'm
Bobby,
trying to...
Focus on me. Forget about the Klan meeting that's happening on the other side of me.
That's Jesus.
Puerto Rican.
They're
my people.
Nicaraguans.
Nicaraguans.
Robert, focus.
Yes.
Forget the fucking Aryans here.
They do have area faces. They do.
Can you put just me and Joe on camera, please?
You're on 6th. Your kid ends up on 6th Avenue. You're out in the city. You're walking around. You and Don, you're having a special day. The kid's in the middle of 6th Avenue. Whose fault is
hold
that?
Hold on, time out. But that's a little different because when you're on the streets of New York City, you do have to hold your kid's hand.
But listen, a zoo, too. Zoo.
No, you don't.
So there could be creepo fucking weirdos. You got to be in eyesight, at least.
Yeah, eyesight. But it's not a good analogy.
Okay, Central Park then, and he's in the fucking.
Yeah, in Central Park, I let my kid's hand go.
But
so
you're keeping an eye on him because it could be some. Jason Cantor could pick him up and run away with him.
Joseph.
It was his
Joseph.
Birthday.
Hold on.
Say it.
It was his birthday.
Joseph.
Yes.
Here's the deal.
You just drive.
You're at a zoo. You're at an exhibit. Yes. Okay? Like, me and Max went to the Tampa Zoo, and there's an exhibit, a snake exhibit, a big fucking boas. And they're inside this thing.
Yeah.
He runs up to the thing, and he's sitting there just watching. He loves snakes. He's sitting there watching snakes. He's going from back and forth. I'm not going to sit there and hold his hand the whole time.
I'm not saying hold his hand.
He's not going to have a good time.
There's no.
I'm not saying hold his hand. You have an eye on him.
I have an eye on him. But there's no way for him to get into the exhibit. If there was a... Dude, this gorilla pit, apparently there was a fucking way for a baby or a child to fall into the pit.
Right.
He went up and over, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah. That shouldn't be an option.
I thought he went under.
And
I
no
went
parent
under.
Knows
I
that.
Under too.
No
I think
parent,
he crawled underneath the thing.
And if I didn't know there was a way for my kid to get into a girl, first of all, I'd be holding his hand at that point. You assume that it's safe enough that you can let your kid's hand go. You got another kid over here screaming and fucking crying for milk. You're looking over here because this other kid's running over here. Yeah. School trips go, dude. They have two or three people, chaperones that come in. They have 30 kids. Do you think they're holding everyone's hand?
If there's hands? A fucking, if there's a 1 second that a kid might go in there, over this, through that, you should eliminate that. There should be no opportunity.
100%. I
that's
agree.
It. So fuck the zoo.
I 100%.
That's who killed the fucking gorilla. The zoo for having a shitty exhibit where a kid can somehow get in there.
And they could have just shot him in the leg.
No, they couldn't have because he would have got pissed and fucking used that kid as a hammer.
But 100%. But like, there's also fucking ways for a guy to come and grab your kid and fucking take him away. There's also ways for a kid to walk in front of a street or a fucking car and get hit. And you got to keep an eye to make sure that doesn't happen.
Yeah, no shit.
Yeah, but it's two different scenarios, dude. You're talking about being at a zoo where you're supposed to...
That'd be a better zoo, just pedophiles in the exhibits.
There you go.
Wow. Not the racist one.
Yeah.
Crime.
Pedophiles
Jap
count.
Pedophiles in them.
You're in. I just don't. I don't think the parents. Yeah, I mean, dude, but stop. Okay, the gorilla's fucking dead.
I'm okay with the gorilla being dead, by the way. They could kill a gorilla for fun. I'd be like, that's great.
Come
good for
on.
You. I mean, I'm not
that
like
should be another
guy.
Exhibit. You just shoot gorillas in the head.
I mean, I'm bummed a gorilla died, but I'm not like a guy that's like, well, you gotta kill the fucking kid or the parents or anything. I'm not saying the parents should go to jail or I don't want to fucking fight him or kill him, but I'm like, you gotta fucking keep an eye on a kid no matter where you are, because something bad can happen.
Of course you do.
Keep
of
an
course
eye
you do.
The kid, it has to take an amount of time. It's
seconds.
Like the door was just opening and walked in.
It's seconds.
Seconds.
It takes seconds, dude.
To go all the way down in there.
Buddy.
He fucking jumped over a little rail and fell into a gorilla enclosure.
I heard that he went under, so I don't even know where you're
doesn't
getting
matter.
Your
info. He shouldn't be able to.
Yeah. But
he shouldn't be able to fucking sneak
well,
into a gorilla exhibit.
Let's find the facts of how long it
the
took.
Argument is very distinct. People that have children and people that don't have children, that's the dividing line.
No, I don't think so. No. There's a lot of parents that are like, fuck those parents. My kid would never. I think it's the opposite. I think where you have two.
No, everyone
is
talking about this online. Is people that don't have kids.
Yeah.
They have no idea what it's like. Dude, you'll see tomorrow. We're going to bring my son to Central Park. We're all going to Central Park, a bunch of comics. Bob, were you invited?
I'll be there.
I was not invited.
Are you kidding?
Not.
I was not
Joe,
invited.
Joe, you didn't invite Bob?
I got the invite.
No,
that
I did
show.
Not
you
get
invited
invite.
Scopo? You didn't invite Bob?
I invited Berg as well.
Yeah,
whoa.
I have.
Wow.
You trash.
Oh!
You trash my fucking picnics so hard. Non-stop, it's all you do. And of course I was going to invite you after I got my money. You trashed my picnic publicly for
Don,
years.
I hope this letter finds
for years.
You well.
You live in Westchester.
Please.
You fucking hate zoos, but you support them. You owe me a grand. And I was going to invite you. And I invited Lewis. I said, invite
I'm
anybody.
I'm so sorry for even mentioning it, Bob.
But you have to sit at the table with Lewis if you go.
Everybody that I invited said, invite whoever. I said, invite whoever. You're under the guise of whoever.
But you did not invite him personally.
You are whoever.
You invited Ari Shaffir.
It was Ari's idea. Ari told me to do the legwork. And
Ari,
he got me on TV.
I'm all right. I'm good. Thanks.
Bob, no, but
barbecue tomorrow?
No, the barbecue.
It's tomorrow.
The barbecue on Sunday is not happening, guys.
Okay. It's, what's wrong with your eye? Why is your eye twitching?
The barbecue is not happening. Scope, sorry. I had to cancel it, so don't show up.
What do you got in your eye, dude? It's twitching a bunch. It keeps closing.
Yeah, dude. The barbecue Sunday is off.
Oh, jeez. All right. So. I couldn't make it anyways because I'm working in Louisville because I need to make some money because I'm owed a bunch. But
PCK has his own town now?
Yeah, it's... that's ridiculous.
Yeah, the people that say, yeah,
Bobby. It's almost ridiculous. Bobby. It's almost fucking ridiculous.
I got to start on Bob.
The fact.
Should have sent a text.
I mean, literally, I took you out of obscurity and put you in front of everybody.
You've been doing comedy for 22 years. Nobody knew who you were.
That's true. You don't know.
Bob.
I mean, it's one thing. Ari didn't have
balloons.
Me on. Ari
balloons.
Had,
remember
Ari,
the balloons? You
Ari
trash
had,
your picnic.
Ari,
you dumb picnic
Ari
with your balloons.
Had
you
everybody
homo.
So you're on the show, and you invite your new friend, your new show friend, Ari.
Excuse me, Bobby. The drink you spilled all over your stuff is dripping all over me.
Yeah, well, maybe it should.
Bobby, he turned a corner on his career. He got a half hour, and now he doesn't even look back
anymore. Ari, you're on Ari's show. I'm out.
All right. I think I might have texted you, actually. Let me see.
You didn't.
Did.
You did not. You did not. You did not text me. You did not mail me. You fucking shun me.
Can I say this, though?
Yes, go
can
ahead.
Can I say this?
Yes.
As an objective judge here, you guys are even now. Just be cool with it.
No,
you
I
didn't hang out with him in L.A. He had to apologize. You didn't invite him to the picnic. It's all out on the table.
You texted, "I will call you when I'm done." That was the last text. I didn't hear anything back after that.
Yeah,
you
just texted, I'm glad I didn't.
That's
hurtful. I'm glad I didn't. I'm glad I didn't text anything back because I'd be crushed today. But now I'm not that crushed.
He really did text Joe, "I hate you."
That's really funny.
So it'll be a great
hey,
time.
Man. Yeah, are you going tomorrow?
Yeah, I'm going to go.
Oh, you were invited?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I texted him.
Deepa, were you invited?
No.
That'd be hilarious, though.
He's invited to my party that's not happening on Sunday.
Yeah. Cool, good to know.
Bob, you got your eye checked out. It keeps twitching, dude.
I'm going to come to your party and bring you some cigars.
It's
Joe
coming? No, I was going to...
If I'm not there, just drop them off at the... There's a mailbox out front.
Sunday.
No,
I can't go out.
You can come, dude. Of course you can.
Robert, I knew I was going to see you today.
Hey, dummy, of course you can come. Hey.
Lauren, you're invited.
You can come.
Thanks.
Wear like a bikini or something.
cool. I'm really fucking hurt, dude.
Bobby, I was gonna.
I can't
you,
believe you, dude.
But here's the thing: I figured you were mad at me because of L.A. You didn't get back to me or anything. The lunch, and then also I don't know if you remember this, but we dedicated 37 episodes to you trashing my fucking picnic, bro. The balloons, remember his dumb balloons. They were too low.
Joe, this time you invite Bobby and show him how
and
much better
I
it's gonna be.
I texted a lot of close friends and said invite whoever.
Order I'm not report. A fucking whoever.
What do you mean? You're somebody.
I'm a fucking original.
Whatever. You're a whoever, dude. But I was going to invite you today because I knew I was going to see. I'm like, and you don't like text?
He was
you don't like
I
text.
Mentioned it.
You hate text?
Was not
he's
gonna,
lying.
No,
he's
that's
lying.
Just in LA.
He's lying to your friend. Joe, I like you more than Bobby, but
what?
I can't watch you. I can't
what?
Watch you lie to the man.
I was going to tell you at the end of this.
I don't.
I wish you were in that gorilla cage.
Oh.
And I wish I was the guy with the gun, and I wouldn't have killed the gorilla. I would have let him fucking slam you around like a fucking, like a banana.
Yeah, you probably would.
I would.
Yeah. You wouldn't even notice I was in there unless it was in L.A. If it wasn't in L.A.
Hey, Bobby, I'm getting tossed around by a gorilla at V-Cut.
Asshole. I can't believe it. There you go. That's the business right there.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the business right there.
That's why I don't invite anybody to anything.
You don't have anything.
You had parties.
This is why I say
Lewis has a guy lunch at least once a year. He invites all of us to that.
The first Monday of the year. It's the fucking.
You've invited me.
I know.
You've invited me a bunch of times.
All dudes.
Yep.
We just fucking eat meat at the Brazilian steakhouse for a fucking 3 hours straight.
Thank you for inviting me, Lewis. I'm sorry I haven't been able to go.
Bob, I would never not invite you to that.
Thank you, buddy.
You're my friend.
Why don't you get off your phone?
I'm at the V-Cut. I'm having a cigar there tomorrow if you want to join.
Yeah.
Lunch? Want to do lunch? Sounds good. Call me when I'm done. Never hear back.
Yeah,
never
you already went through and apologized.
Yeah, I apologized and you accepted it.
I'm sorry that I hadn't yet invited you.
You weren't
although
invited
I did
me.
Invite you because I said, Aaron, tell whoever.
Here's the problem with
tell
you.
Tell whoever.
Here's the problem with you.
Tell whoever you want.
I'm
Bobby,
not, am
some
I
other
whoever?
Douche.
Am I whoever? Am I not an original?
Look at all these texts. No response, by the way.
Are you a fucking Hey.
Come on, let's get down and dirty. Look at all these unanswered texts. It's crazy. Right. All blue. Everything's blue.
Joe, you kind of look like the psycho. Buddy.
Everybody, blue, blue, blue. Buddy, dude, look at
your
like
Bobby. Where are you? What's in the tub?
Blue.
Thought maybe you
poo.
Called.
Blue.
Buddy.
Bobby was drying my hair. Thought maybe you called.
Buddy, oh, this is a good
are
one.
You
this
okay?
You.
Worried about you. Been hours.
You had one that was, you called me a whale.
No, I didn't.
You had a photo of a whale, and that's what you said.
No, that was hilarious. I go, I sent, this is funny. This is good stuff. I sent a picture of my poop. Hold on. What did I write? It was pretty funny, I think. I wrote, want to go fishing, and I took a picture of this poop that looks like a fish hook, which is hilarious. And then you wrote, dude. And I wrote question mark, and you wrote dude again, and I wrote no good question mark.
I was sitting down with Max about to have food, and that comes up on my phone, and then Max goes, poopy? And I went, ugh. So I wrote back dude, because I was about to eat. And he's sending me pictures.
And
of
I wrote, I'm sorry, I thought you would like it.
This perfect J shit.
And then I wrote, I know you didn't like the last picture of one of my dumps, but you got to see this one. It's insane. And then I posted this picture.
What is it?
Let me see.
It's a whale.
Yeah.
It's a whale underwater with bubbles coming out of it.
Yeah.
That's classically funny. And then you know what his response was? I don't know. Hasn't responded yet. That was February 8th. And then February 11th, 3 days later, I wrote nothing on that text. I couldn't stop laughing. You've changed, bro. Hashtag bully. You know what his response was? Zilch.
Call me a bully. Why would I respond to somebody who's calling me a bully? Who's a bully? March. He's a fucking nerd bully.
Well, you're also a Chizzler, so you're probably on your boat somewhere.
Tuesday, March 8th.
He's got no service on his boat while he's gambling with women.
Tuesday, March 8th. I'm trying to call you, but it's going straight to voicemail, and your box is full. I hope you're not dead.
You talking to Lauren?
No response. No response.
Stop saying you wish. Yeah, it's making me furious.
You get it.
I'm not.
I'll fucking put my dick in you so deep.
What about this? April 5th. I write you around,
so
dog.
Deep. Or 5 inches.
Yeah. Yeah. Yo, it's around 5 inches, and that's as deep as it goes.
First time I fuck Lauren, I get a full fucking rock
hard.
Yeah,
so it'd be 5.5.
Almost 6.
Yeah. And then he thrust a little bit.
We'd literally have to tie fucking yard rope around your nuts and pull from a door. To make your dick sex.
I'd make she'd like it.
All right. We're going to wrap this up. I lost a friend today, but that's cool. Yeah. All right. Let's go around the room real quick. Let's go to the chat room real quick. What do we got in the chat room?
Not much.
Oh, that's not what I want to hear, but fucking work it out. Improv on the fly.
Dearest Deepu.
Wow, Deepu. You fucking.
I got nothing, man.
You should get something.
All right, can you come back to me?
Yes, I will. I was going to do that. Can you not explain the behind the scenes of how the show works?
Uh-oh, Bobby, someone else texted you and got no answer.
Who?
Chris Stanley.
Who?
The guy from Bennington.
Oh, producer, big show.
I'm answering him today.
Oh, yeah. He sent me a text.
Yeah,
email.
Buddy.
Tell Chris he
can
didn't
we fucking
my
deal
email.
With this right away? Fuck text messaging. It's for children. I'm a grown fucking man.
This is why I didn't
call
text him at the party.
Call me and say, Bobby, it's Joe.
Bobby,
it's Joe.
Well, your box is full, so.
My box is not full.
Box is full.
It's not full.
Sometimes it is.
It's full.
Because you
fucking
don't
text
get
I
got
fuck it. Look at all the text messages. Look at this, okay? Look at all the text messages. One, look at. Spinning. We're still going. Spinning. All these fucking text messages. Call me. Fucking call. Do I like phone calls?
He likes phone calls.
I call you.
You do call me, and we talk, and what happens?
Yeah. Shit gets done.
Exactly. Deepu?
What happened?
Well, can you do the thing?
By the way.
I want to do it. What is it?
Friday.
This Friday?
Yeah.
What time?
He didn't say.
Find out time, but yes, I'll be in the city at 12.
Text him and find out what time.
Yeah. And tell him if Bobby doesn't do it, I got to get on to promote my album, so I'll be there.
Tell him I'll do it, and please don't bring up Aaron in my text.
Mm-hmm. I will never do that.
Thanks.
And tell him not to drink the almond milk in the guest digital studio anymore.
What do I got coming up? Atlanta Laughing Skull Fest next week.
Listen, man, this is a weird show to come on. Did you have fun?
I had a great time, man.
You're a little quiet.
Yeah, I got a little bit more comfortable after a bit.
Yeah, you
just
did.
Just getting used to the.
I had a fucking bunch of rowdy fucks on, and Joe usually is a sniper, but today he was just an attacker and an abuser. He abused me today.
A Chizzler, if you will.
I apologize for the abuse.
Oh no, it was a blast, man.
I got attacked today, on all fronts, and I lost a friend. So, maybe me and you could be friends.
Yeah, you were friends with that gorilla.
I'll stick around.
I thought that was okay.
Hey, dude, thanks for coming on, dude. What's your Twitter?
At Tyler Morrison 1.
And what's your website?
TylerMorrison.ca.
And where's your next show? What is it?
Oh, Canada.
Yeah, it's Canada.
Why
then
would you choose that, though?
Squatting on the .com.
So wouldn't you just do TylerMorrisonComedy.com?
No, just
.ca. The government owns it.
Is it less money to do CA?
No,
it's just probably the same. But
how long have you been in New York?
I just got in yesterday. So I'm doing...
Are you really?
Yeah, New York Comedy Club tonight. I'm going to do a spot.
You just live in Canada now?
Yeah, I'm from Canada.
Oh, that's great, man. So you're going back when?
Friday.
And we got a bunch of people that from Toronto that listen to the show and Edmonton and all that. So you're near Toronto.
Yep.
And where's your club there?
It's the Yuck Yucks downtown Toronto club.
I actually went there. What a cool club.
It's a great club.
Yuck Yucks a good club. You played Yuck Yucks, right?
I did, yeah.
Yeah, I like Yuck Yucks.
Yeah, it's a good chain. They got clubs all across the country. So.
Yeah, that's like their main chain. Like that's their improv, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
And who's the guy who owns that?
Mark Breslin.
Is he a nice guy?
Yeah, he's been good to me.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
It's great.
You have to say that if they book you.
Well, no. I mean, what's good for you is good. You know, I say that, you know, about the clubs that book me. But
like I just
don't have to. It's probably true.
I just started working with his clubs probably, I guess last September. So I've been doing stand-up on my own independently and then started doing his clubs.
And
you
guys are friends from Canada?
Yeah, Toronto. I'm with Yuck Yucks as well.
And you're with Yuck Yucks? Yeah. Yuck Yucks? Okay, cool, man. Lewis, what do you got? Besides whatever the fuck you're doing.
Turn Lauren on right now?
All right, I'm going to go to Aaron, and I'll come back this
week. No, I got it. All right, I'm good.
Would you rather turn her on or give your avails?
It's fine. I'll give my avails. Guys, it's not my avails.
I know. I just wanted to see if you gave the avails.
Guys, this is my shit. GomezComedy.com. GomezComedy.
Your eyebrows are fading.
Are you ready?
You need to get eyebrow plugs.
What's my problem with my eyebrows?
They're fading. They're falling out. The older people get... Sure, yours is falling.
Hey,
out.
Rebecca, I'll call you right back.
Is that Rebecca who? Rebecca who?
Rebecca Chang, you want to say hi to Bob?
Yeah, say hi.
Hold on, we're on YKWD. Hold on.
Put her on speakerphone. Of course she did. Okay, go ahead.
GomezComedy.com, Gomez Comedy on Instagram. Guys, check out my other shows, Legion of Skanks, now every Wednesday night, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, live from the Creek in the Cave if you guys want to sit in. Also on GasDigitalNetwork.com every Wednesday at 9 p.m. Realize Podcast, Wednesdays at noon with myself and Scopo and Chris Tinkle and Zach Amico. Also check out The Countdown, SiriusXM, Rush 93, every Thursday, 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time with myself and Michael Bisping. And Skankfest 2016 is here. We're ready to fucking rock. Joe Liss is on it. Aaron Berg is on it. Bob Kelly's fucking one of the major acts that are on the show. Bob, don't even... I mean, I'm going to peg you in the face.
Why?
If you... Don't make that face. Were you releasing pheromones? What was that face?
I'm actually... Okay.
Did you fart?
We'll figure it out.
Bob, you're on the fucking...
That's we'll a double figure it out.
Listen to me.
What's this?
Don't fuck with me.
Oh, listen to me.
Skankfest is going to be, I mean, beyond that, we got Ari Shaffir, Sal Vacano from The Impractical Jokers, Michael Che from Saturday Night Live, lots of podcasts, stand-up shows, showcases, the Naked Roast Battle with Zach Amico hosting it with his little fucking dick and fat body. Yeah. It's going to be hilarious. Go to creeklic.com.
Sorry.
18th and 19th of June, plus Big J's one-hour special is premiering on the 17th at midnight.
Are you promoting Big J?
I'm not done, fuckface. If you have VIP passes to Skankfest, you get to come to the launch party on Friday night at the Creek.
Get off your phone, you fucking dumb
asshole. Let me
fucking
finish my fucking plugs.
Don't ever raise a hot coffee.
Aaron used to have plugs.
If you get Skankfest NYC VIP passes, you can come to the kickoff party Friday night at the Creek in the Cave, where we will be premiering Jay's special that's airing that night. You get to hang out, watch
all
it with
right,
all of us.
God.
Bennington's doing a fucking set on the show.
All right.
Free balloon animals for the kids.
Mark Norman, Mike Lawrence, Sam Morrell.
All right, dude, we get it. You, I asked for you.
Rich Voss.
Not fucking everybody who's ever done this show.
I'm promoting Skankfest, which you don't do, Bob.
You can catch me on YKWD. You don't do it.
You don't do it.
Podcast.
All right, so.
Guys, check out Opie in the Mornings. Also, the Anthony Cumia Show. I think they're friends now.
Channel 45, Comedy Central.
I don't know.
They've got comedy all the time.
I think Anthony took down.
Yeah, your mic's on.
Is it? Is it? Hello? Yeah. I feel like they've put a lot of the shit behind them.
How do you know that?
Because Anthony took down the Torpid Sloth t-shirt line that he had.
Well, that maybe it wasn't selling anymore.
No, but then Anthony also said
I love selling.
What did he say?
He just said something about them being cool now. And I know when he was in rehab, Obi tweeted out something really nice. Being
oh,
like,
good.
I wish
man,
him the
that
best.
Would make me so happy if they got back together.
I don't think they'd get back together.
I mean,
together.
But back to, you know.
Became friends again. Well, did each other shows.
Reunited the fan base, too, so it wasn't such a split, you know, down the middle, where mm-hmm. with him and where with, you know.
Yeah. I hope we can do that, too, buddy.
Yeah, no, it's not going to happen. Yeah, it's a wrap. Yeah. You'll get your money. That all that matters to you. You'll get that. Maybe you can.
I can bring it tomorrow to the barbecue.
Yeah, I'll give it to you.
Yeah.
I'll give it to you. You'll get it. Thanks.
Barbecue's not tomorrow.
Oh, picnic. Sorry.
Is it my turn?
No, not yet. The fuck was I going to say to you, Lewis? I had something I was. Oh, Bisbing. He's fighting for the title.
Yeah, Saturday night.
What do you think?
Put $100 on him. He's a plus 700 underdog.
Put $100 for me.
You really want me to?
No. I don't.
You don't want this Chizzler owing you $100.
Dude, all right, buddy, that's fucking huge.
Thanks for coming on, dude.
Thank you, brother.
Yeah, and I'm happy. It sounds like you're doing great.
Yeah, it's coming together.
You're doing good, man. You've grown up a lot in the last year.
Yeah.
You've become a very, you've kept your edge.
Yeah.
You kept the way you are, but you've.
Sober, 3 months.
You're a nicer guy. You're not as insecure and angry.
You're a faggot.
Yep, see? Thanks. I love you, Lewis.
Not you, Bob.
I love you, man.
Not you, Bob.
I love you.
No, man. No, Bob.
I love you, man.
No, Bob.
I love you, Lewis.
I love you.
I love you, too.
I love you.
I see you. I feel you.
What do you got, Aaron?
That's the song from the Titanic.
We got it.
Canadian.
My brand new album, Unscripted, available on iTunes right now. My books, Mr. Manners and American Etiquette. You can get them on Amazon, Barnes & Noble. My Twitter is at Aaron Berg Comedy. My brand new podcast with Gino Visconti on the Kumia Network airs Wednesdays as soon as Legion of Skanks leaves.
That shouldn't be annoying.
Yeah. And then
Gino Visconti.
Well, yeah. Wait, are you competing with us on Wednesdays?
Are you on Wednesdays?
What time is your show?
What time is your show?
9 p.m.
We'll go at 9. And then...
wow, they're taking your place?
Nobody watch you.
They're taking your place?
Yeah, no, they're taking our place.
No, I'm not sure what
they're
Gino's
good. He's
actually
good on the radio.
Gino's unbelievable. Gino's great. I'm the biggest fan of Aaron and Gino there are. Nobody else
I like
them.
Aaron. I like Gino on other things. I'll never have him on the show again.
Yeah.
Gino
if you show? Care about the product, it's very annoying. But if you sit back and watch it as a fan, it's hilarious.
Yeah, I cannot... I will never have him on the show again.
Why?
He stinks. He doesn't shut the fuck up.
Yeah.
He's just an annoying. He's like a woodpecker. It fucking stinks. Yeah. But I like Gino a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What are you talking about, Lewis?
Go ahead.
Yeah. What else is going on? I'll be at Caroline's on Broadway June 23rd. I'll be at Laugh It Up Comedy Club in Poughkeepsie June 25th. And August 25th, I'll be at the Exotica Porn Convention in Columbus.
How many people do you think listen to the show?
All right. 80,000.
Jesus Christ. What do you got, dude?
Bob, you just keep skipping me.
Yeah, what do you got? What do you got coming on?
I'm just going back to Toronto. I have a run of Yuck Yucks that I'm doing.
So you run it? Oh, you
no, I have a run of shows coming up with them a bunch of weekends.
Okay, can you work on the accent? Just become more American, you know?
Yeah, I know. It's pretty brutal. I'm from the backwoods.
It was nice having you on, dude.
We got a podcast, too, called Rude Dudes Podcast.
Rude Dudes.
Yeah,
oh, cool, man. I'll check it out, man. What is it on just rudedudes.com, iTunes? What is it?
Yeah, it's on iTunes.
Rudedudes.ca.
Deepu, what do you got?
I have some chat room stuff if you want.
Sure.
Probably requests for my plugs.
GG says...
Gary Gullman?
Maybe.
Craig Gutfeld?
Possibly.
Gary Identity. GG
He says Bobby only interrupts Lewis during his plugs.
Yeah.
Very disrespectful.
Yeah. Well, I do it because it's our thing.
Yeah, he got a plug at least.
Go ahead.
The only time Bobby's box is when it's full of donuts.
Mm.
We all thought that. Nobody said it.
Yeah, because you're not hacks. That was too easy.
Low-hanging donuts.
Christkiller says, Bobby can't go to the zoo because every time he tries to leave, they sound the alarm.
That's not bad.
It was close. It was there. I feel it was a little too...
Is it my reading it?
Having Deepu be the vehicle for that joke was just bad.
Yeah, but no, it was a little too wordy. I think he's a good filter for jokes. Mm. Because if it's good, it has to be really good to be funny.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because he'll take an okay joke and just bury it.
His arms make me want to puke. Look at the hair.
I know. I got the joke.
I actually had one of my arms shaved, and Bobby was a lot nicer to me for that couple weeks. I think he just slowly appreciated it.
It's disgusting.
He just called you racist, bro.
Go ahead. What else?
Me?
Sorry.
Me?
I mean, did you get all just attacking Bob? Is there anything else was said?
It's a lot of fat
just
jokes.
Just attacking me? Is that it?
No, we got a racist thing.
Yeah.
Well, hang terrific. On. What is it?
The head of Comedy Central. Lewis will never work on this network.
Jizz Jam says.
That's an old one.
Jizz Jam says, some blacks got in my pool. Now I have to drain the Negro agua.
Can you block that person?
Oof.
That's just terrible.
Can you send that person to my information to contact us at Cumia Network, please?
Yeah.
Great.
Fucking Christ, man. How do you even write that? All right. Scopo, what do you got?
June 30th. Lewis, what are we doing June 30th? We're doing a gig.
Are we?
Yeah.
Shouldn't he know it as the guy that's supposed to promote your gig for you?
Yeah, June 30th, guys. New Jersey.
The guy actually hit me up yesterday. I saw him at Caroline's, and he was like, oh, you're doing a gig
in
a fucking amphitheater.
An amphitheater? What's whatever an amphitheater?
I saw him at Caroline's.
What
and
the
he
fuck?
Said we're doing an amphitheater. I don't know what that's what he said. An amphitheater.
What's an amphitheater?
It's an amphitheater.
Yeah, it's like I don't know. What a fucking
it's an outdoor big
you
venue.
You have 22
yeah.
people in an amphitheater. Hello.
All right. Is that all you got?
Yeah. And then your dates right here.
Wait, I didn't ask for those yet. Lauren, what's your tell the fan what you got?
At Lauren Kubera, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.
Yeah. Are you gonna bang?
Lauren,
Lewis?
You
no.
Would you at least make out with me? Just a kiss.
No.
Lauren,
can
Lauren,
I
get
it's a fair deal, Lil?
What?
I'm getting married and I'm gonna have a bachelor party and I think I get like one last thing.
Yeah.
Do you want to be that thing?
We'll talk about it.
Thing.
So wait a minute. Can
Whoa.
I ask you one question, what? Lauren? Out of Lewis or Aaron, who would you go on a date with?
I'm not answering these questions.
Why?
Because
you have to answer the questions.
No.
Just say which one would it be. So you like Lewis. You'd go
I don't,
on,
I,
would you
I
go on a date
Lewis.
With him? Would
no.
you go on a date with him?
I'm not, no. We're not.
You wouldn't
no,
even make out
not.
With him. Just a
why?
Quick make out session.
What's why?
Sexual pleasure.
What do you jizz your pants in a makeout?
I get turned on during a makeout. I love making out.
Yeah.
Me too.
When you get older.
Me too.
Is we do a three-way dude makeout?
No.
What else we got? People want to send stuff here. What are they going to do?
YKWDproducer@riotcast.com. You could email us stuff, fan stuff for the shelves. And
the address?
And the address, 117 McDougal Street.
Yeah, go ahead, Chris.
That was it. 117 McDougal Street, 10012.
Hang on 1 second. We got you.
He's just showing his arms.
So, yeah, all the stuff behind us is actually from you guys. You want to mail something to the studio, please send it in care of YKWD Robert Kelly.
And it's all for sale. If anybody wants to buy anything, there's a price for everything.
Yeah, I got to start raising money to pay Joe back. So,
send in stuff that Bobby can throw at Lewis. That should be fun. Like a mace.
It'd be good to get like a Nerf. Wow.
Wait, a mace?
Ooh, a Nerf gun. Ooh, we should get a Nerf gun.
Like, you mean like spray mace?
No, I was thinking like that medieval weapon.
But the ball with the spikes on it. It's worse.
It's way more violent.
Hit Lewis in the fucking head with it. All right. And what else? Oh, yeah. Premium channel.
Yeah, get the app. It's really cool.
Yeah, get the app. It's amazing. It's free. It's for iOS. It's for Android. And you can join right there. Just fill out the form. It's 2 seconds. It comes right out of your phone, your iTunes, or whatever account, and you get all the premium stuff. And the latest premium thing is the video from the PodFest.
Yep.
Is up there right now, video and audio. Mm-hmm. Only premium members get it. So go to riotcast.com, YKWD/YKWD, hit the premium button, or just go get the app for free for your phone. Robert Kelly, you know what, dude, app.
I got an idea for selling
right here,
those.
Bobby.
What's up?
For selling the premium. I'm being serious.
Yeah.
You release for free the podcast minus my voice. That's the free. And then if you buy premium, you get my shit.
Right, yeah.
You just sell it like hotcakes.
Joe, where do we go from here?
Can I plug a couple dates? I got nothing big. It's small. All I have is Wednesday, tomorrow afternoon, everybody on Earth is invited. Central Park, Sheep Meadow. There'll be balloons. I think it's a good way, a smart way to let people know where. Yeah.
It's going to be very low to the ground. You probably won't be able to see them or find the party. And then when you go there, all the food you brought is going to be eaten by fucking open micers because they don't bring any food. And then you and your child and
we
your wife will
food?
Just fucking.
No, you have to bring anything.
There's no food, really.
Yeah.
I brought food last time.
We know, Bob.
And you guys all
he's
ate.
Carried food in your book bag at
the
all times.
The only other thing is I have the number one podcast on iTunes. It's called Tuesdays with Stories.
Not even in the top 200.
Check it out.
remember when Joe had 10 million subscribers?
Oh, from Stand Up Labs?
Yeah, remember that? 10 million. Dude, 10 million people? Fucking, really?
Why more subscribers than Lady Gaga.
Why do you have 2,000 people on Twitter then?
Har-di-har.
What else you got? Will you stop jerking off the fucking gavel?
Don't creepishly look at me while you do it.
Jesus,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, you're sexually harassing.
Oh, my God. That's so nice.
Anyways, I have dates in Cincinnati and Louisville and a bunch of other places. But I got
Louis has his own city?
You tried that earlier.
No, I don't know if
we
you guys heard it.
No, we heard it.
We got it.
And it literally made me throw up in my mouth the second time.
Do you know what literally means?
Urban Dictionary.
But yeah, come out because
look at what literally means.
I don't have a lot of work. I'm a little low on money right now.
Well, what are you gonna do?
Yeah, I'm gonna throw parties in the only place I can, a free
sure.
space.
I'm gonna go. I'm gonna stay. I'm gonna do tomorrow. I'm gonna stay home and write.
With me, the show.
No, I'm gonna write. I'm gonna write.
Why don't we pick
show?
Up the show? Why don't we pick up where we left off?
Why don't you fucking pick up? Well, I gotta pay you. I gotta make sure I pay you for your final draft first.
I can really use final draft, by the way.
Yeah. Why don't we write
bucks.
A show together? I'll pay half.
Why don't you invite me to write a show with you?
No, Bobby, just offer and then don't.
What, Aaron?
Just
what
wanted
else?
To say a big thank you for coming out and doing that fundraiser. And we raised a whole bunch of money for Fort McMurray, and it was sent to those people in Canada. So thanks for doing that. I know you get a hard time about how much you Jew your money and don't share it with your friends. And I just appreciated you donating your time to that charity. So thank
yeah.
you.
Got it, yeah. Very un-Chizzler-like. Yeah.
Thanks,
you.
Joe.
Yeah.
Donating your time.
All right, we're going to wrap it up.
Nothing? Low-hanging donuts? Come on, that was something.
That was pretty good.
Donutting your time.
Deepu, what do you got, anything?
Twitter, Instagram, R2Deepu, that's it.
All right, make sure you guys follow all the comics that are on the show today on their social media. And if you see them live, go check them out. And make sure you tell them you heard about them on the YKWD. Support all these guys when they do their shows. And give it up for Joe List for, being such a fucking friend today.
Yeah, great friend. I tried to hook up and hang out. And what did you press? Did you press the turn off button? Is it off?
You guys are the best fans.
Wait, I got your dates.
I'll give my dates. Go ahead.
Okay, June 18th, House of Independence, Asbury Park.
Big show.
Huge.
Huge show. Asbury Park. Let's fill this up. Go.
Day before Skankfest.
June 24th, 25th, McGuire's, Bohemia, New York.
Well, no, the 24th, you're at the Brokerage.
Oh, sorry. But
it says McGuire's, but you're at the Brokerage.
I'm at the Brokerage.
All right.
And the 25th.
And McGuire's. Then the 1st through the 8th, you'll be in Aruba.
Aruba, baby. I got a bunch of new shows coming out. Again, I said I had the tour coming out in the fall. And then there's a bunch of other dates coming out, too. So I hope you guys buy the tickets and go to my website, robertkellylive.com, and it will tell you when I'm going to be in and around doing shows around you. You guys are the best fans in the world. Thanks so much for listening. You guys in the live chat room, you guys are the best. Go fuck yourselves, and I love you. You know what?
You've been listening to the YKWD podcast. Thanks for listening. Now go back to your shitty jobs.
Shitty jobs.
Check out riotcast.com for all of the best podcasts on the internet. And they are all free.
And they are all free.